Empty, empty, full, okay? Watch this. Which one?
Bro, I can see it in your hoodie. Take it off or I'm not playing.
Okay, fine.
Bro, you've been playing with me, bro. I don't have time for this.
I don't even know. Okay, empty, empty, full, okay?
Okay.
Which one is it?
Bro, it's the middle one.
Are you sure?
I'm so positive, I'll bet you my golden Xbox.
Okay, but if you get it wrong, everybody has to subscribe.
Okay.
Empty, empty, full.
What the heck?
Richer.
No, I'm richer.
This is my best friend Shutters, and he thinks he's richer than me, but I don't think so.
So today we're gonna find out who is richer. Level one, who has more stuff?
I'm so rich, I have a golden PS5.
Well, I'm so rich that my play button is diamond.
Level two, feelings.
I'm rich because I have my pet's love.
Me too.
Shutters, that's a stuffed animal.
Bruh. Level three, who has more money?
I have $69.69.
What?
And finally, subscribe if you think I'm richer, and like if you think I'm richer.
This ruined our friendship. Let me explain. This is my best friend, Brandon, and he thinks his shoes are the coolest. But I think my shoes are way cooler.
So today we're gonna figure out whose shoes are better. First, we're gonna see who can jump higher. Bro, so trash.
No way.
Second test, who can kick better?
I got this.
No way. How?
Shoot.
Here we go.
No way.
Oh.
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 Goal! Third test, which shoes look cooler?
Shoes are pointless.
What? And finally, subscribe if you think my shoes are better,
and like if you think mine are.
This just changed my life. Let me explain. These are my brand new shoes and I feel amazing in them. I never take them off. Not to shower, not to sleep, and not even to swim. But I noticed that my best friend doesn't like when I wear them.
Wish I had those. I'm gonna steal them.
Shutters, what are you doing?
I'm just cleaning your shoes.
Leave me alone. I'm not taking them off.
Plan B, bribing his girlfriend.
It's either me or the shoes!
Fine. See you later!
Topper, everyone watching, likes and subscribes, you have to give me your shoes!
Okay, fine!
Guys, please!
Don't talk into the mic and I'll buy you whatever you want.
Topper! He can play.
Wait, what's your name?
McKinley.
How old are you?
20.
Okay, I mean, I guess you win. All right, where do you want to go?
Yay, I want something from Prada.
Oh, great. Yeah,
run your pockets.
Let's go. All
right, McKinley, he has 30 million followers. Get whatever you want.
I can run it up?
Run it up.
I mean, you didn't talk, so I guess so.
All right, we're here, Prada. All right, give me your card.
Okay, I'll tell you what. If you follow me, I'll give you this.
Okay, bet, yeah.
We already follow you, yeah.
Okay, let me see. Okay, and okay, all right, go crazy.
Yeah.
I can see her through the window. She's looking at such an expensive bag. No.
All right, Topper, we spent over $4,100.
Yeah, I know. I got the notification.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sorry. Thank you, though.
Yeah. Sorry.
Bye. He can't believe I gave this to him.
Let me explain. This is my best friend, Shutters, and his favorite animal is sharks. But recently, he's been really sad because he just lost his shark toy he's had forever.
So today, I'm gonna be a good friend and surprise him with a new one.
Shutters, I have something for you.
Topper, I'm not in the mood.
Bro, trust me.
If it's not Mr. Shark, I don't want it. It is way better.
It's the Beast Lab Save the World Challenge.
Bro, this is already so cool.
Come on, keep going. It gets better.
As each experiment proceeds, it only gets more intense. That is a cloud of real biomass.
Bro, this is the coolest thing ever.
Dude, this is so cool.
Wait till the end for the final reveal.
Oh, you see the toy in there?
Whoa.
Whoa.
Bro, this is so much better than Mr. Shark.
Who's weirder?
Oh, bro, definitely Shutters.
Bro, this guy.
No.
Topper, what are you doing?
You don't make your quesadillas on the toilet?
Yeah, but not with mayo.
Shutters, what are you doing?
Making a bowl of cereal.
With the milk first?
Who smells better?
Oh, definitely me.
Bro, me.
You guys both stink.
What?
Who's smarter?
Bro,
100% me, bro. I'm a genius.
No, you're not. I'm smarter.
Whoever can finish your test first is smarter. Ready? Go.
Damn. Bro, I don't think that's what he meant by finish the test.
Bruh.
How is this unbreakable? Let me explain. This is the world's strongest pig, and it's completely indestructible.
So today, we're gonna try and break it.
Level one, punching it in the face.
too weak. Let me try. Wow! Level 2 drop test.
Get the drop from higher.
Oh. How?
What?
For the final level, subscribe if you think the pig is not going to break.
And like if you think it will.
Extreme stretch test.
Ow!
It didn't break, guys. Subscribe.
The other day, I heard the scariest noise in my house. You can say I was a little scared. I searched everywhere to try and find what it was, and then I heard this. Who could be here? I followed it and was really scared. I then opened the door and it tried to attack me. I ran as fast as I could to my best friend's room to tell him what I just saw. We now both bravely walked to find the mystery creature that I just saw, and we heard it eating our food. It was time to get it out of the house. But when we looked, it was gone. I then woke up and it was all just a nightmare. Play with us! If you blink, you lose. Level easy. If you made it to level medium, hit that subscribe button.
It hurts.
Stinks!
If you made it to level hard, drop a like. If you made it to level impossible, comment. This is my best friend Shutters, and the other day he said this.
I'll be your friend no matter what, Topper.
So today I'm gonna put that to the test.
First, I'm going to push him into the pool.
Are you mad?
No, I needed a shower today.
Bruh. Wait, what about your phone?
I needed a new one anyways.
Second, hiding his food. Was starting to give up until I thought of this idea.
I'm going to throw away his golden PS5.
Subscribe if you think this will make him mad.
Where's my golden PS5?
I threw it away.
Xbox is better anyways.
What?
The other day I went to bed early, but when I woke up, I was on the couch. Whatever, I guess it doesn't matter. The next day I locked the door to make sure nobody could come in. I went to sleep and woke up in the middle of the pool? How is this possible? Tonight I am going to make sure I don't go anywhere. I tied myself tight to the bed, but when I woke up, I was on the roof? Why is this happening? So that night I put a dummy in my bed to simulate I was sleeping there and waited for the culprit to come. And eventually, I saw them. I ran as fast as I could and took off the mask. What? You won't believe who it was. Subscribe if you want me to tell you. Play with us. If you breathe, you lose. Level easy. If you made it to level medium, drop a comment. If you made it to level hard, hit that subscribe button. If you made it to level impossible, give it a like. We are having a major disagreement. Let me explain. This is my best friend Shutters, and he won't stop drinking Coke, which is ridiculous because Pepsi is way better.
So today, we're gonna find out which one is better. Test number one. Let's see how high I can jump after drinking Pepsi. Here we go! Oh, that was actually really good!
Team Coke is way better!
Shutters?
Level 2, taste test.
These taste the exact same.
What? Level 3, which one will make the bigger explosion?
Oh.
Ooh. Oh. Come on, Pepsi, come on. Oh. Let's go. Like the video if you think Pepsi's better,
and subscribe if you think Coke is better.
This has to to be illegal. Let me explain. Today when I was playing with my balls, I thought of something. How many ketchup packets are in a ketchup bottle? So I knew what I had to do. Go to every single fast food restaurant within a 100-mile radius and ask for as many ketchup packets as possible.
Can I have a little bit more ketchup? Is that okay?
Thank you so much.
Can I do one more ketchup?
Appreciate it, bro. Thank you.
Once I got all the ketchup, it was time to get filling. Just like it's hard to fill this ketchup bottle, it's also hard to like and subscribe at the same time. I was almost out of ketchup until my best friend Shutters gave me some of his secret stash. And we figured out it takes
669 packets.
He just wasted all of his money. Let me explain. This is Fiji water, and it costs $5 per bottle. And this is regular water, and regular water costs 50 cents per bottle. And my friend Shutters won't stop drinking Fiji water. So today, I am going to put him to the ultimate test.
Shutters, stop playing with your balls.
Why?
Because I wanted to tell you you should drink regular water instead of Fiji water. It tastes the same.
No, it doesn't. Fiji's the best.
If you can tell me which one is regular water and which one is Fiji water, you can keep playing with your balls.
Bro, that's... I got this.
All right, let's see it. Okay, which one do you think that is? Take a big sip.
Oh, oh my gosh. Bro. That tastes like sink water.
What do you think?
Bro, this is Fiji 100%, bro. This is so good. Did I get it right?
No.
Bruh.
I can't believe this is true.
Starbucks is now giving a golden Frappuccino from their secret menu if you have a Starbucks tattoo.
So I got an idea. I started by calling a professional body paint artist, showing her exactly what I wanted painted on my body, and paying her $10,000 for this realistic Starbucks drink tattoo. Then I headed over to Starbucks and asked,
I heard that if I have a Starbucks drink tattoo like this, I get a free golden drink. Is that true?
If this works, everybody has to subscribe. They called my name and it's a golden Starbucks drink. Make me cry, win $100.
Once I was 2 and I came back from my dad's, and then like my pet fish died and they had to flush him down the toilet.
Bruh.
Your videos, like every time I watch them, they make my day.
I'm subscribed.
You're subscribed? You're not gonna make me cry, but here's $20.
Make me cry and win $100.
You're never gonna hit 20 million subscribers on YouTube.
You know, here, just take the money.
Bruh.
Dude, why does everybody say that?
Today, I got amazing news.
McDonald's is now giving golden burgers from their secret menu if you have a burger tattoo.
And this got me thinking. I was able to fake my way into getting a free Subway for Life card. So this should be a piece of cake. The plan was simple. I reached out to a professional body paint artist, explained to her exactly what I wanted, and paid her $10,000 for this realistic looking burger tattoo. Then I found the nearest McDonald's, and it was time to put this to the test. I waited nervously in line until it was my turn and asked,
I heard that if I have a Big Mac tattoo like this, I get a free Big Mac. Is that true?
Will it actually work? They called out my number and it came out with a special box. No way! It's a golden burger! So as I was about to shower today, I remembered something. I'm more of a bath type of guy. And that got me thinking. It takes 5,437 Doritos to fill a bathtub. I wonder how many tablespoons of water it takes. I got right to work. And let me tell you, this was taking way longer than I expected. And then it hit me. The drain was opened. So back to square one. After doing this nonstop for what felt like a lifetime, well, except for that one break, I was exhausted, but so close. So I pushed myself and found out it takes exactly
26,352.
This is the biggest surprise of her life. Let me explain. This is my girlfriend, Annie, and recently, she's been sad.
So today, I'm gonna try and cheer her up. Baby, let's see who can finish their candy first.
Okay.
And go.
I did it.
Really? Okay, baby, now let's see who can land their bottle first.
Okay.
3, 2, 1, flip. Baby, look, you did it. Now let's see who will win in rock, paper, scissors, okay?
Okay.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot!
I won! I won!
Oh! Baby, if you win this last one, everybody watching will subscribe.
Okay, okay.
Whoever can land their cup first wins. Ready, set, go! Oh! Oh! Baby, you got it! Subscribe! I want this one!
Okay, let's see what you didn't win.
Come on, please, please.
You put it on that, Mr. Beast!
Are you serious?
Okay, do you want to switch or keep it?
I want to switch.
Okay.
I want this one.
All right, let's see what you didn't win.
Give me something good.
You could have had a big, juicy can.
Sharks, can I please still have
it? No. Okay, do you want to switch or keep it?
I'll switch.
Okay.
I want this one.
All right, let's see what you could have got.
Give me something.
You could have got a brand new PS5.
Xbox is better anyway.
Bruh. What? Okay, do you want to switch or keep it?
I'll switch it again.
Okay, let's see what you could have got.
What is it?
You could have met Messi.
Oh, dude, Ronaldo's better anyway.
Okay, let's see what you want.
Okay, come on, let's see what I
want. Subscribe.
Everyone has to subscribe, let's go.
My name is Topper, and I am obsessed with my new shoes. And recently, my best friend asked,
hey Topper, can I borrow your shoes?
No way, bro, your feet stink.
I'm gonna get those shoes.
Hey, Top, you see my new sign? Do you see I don't care?
What did he say?
Plan B. If I can't have them, no one can.
Oh!
Oh, tires!
Oh, I'm so sorry!
It'll come right off. Don't worry, bro.
Shutters, what's wrong?
I just really want to wear your shoes.
Okay, I'll tell you what. If everybody watching likes and subscribes, I'll let you wear them.
Guys, please like and subscribe!
Wait, Jack? Don't talk into the mic and I'll buy you whatever you want.
Topper?
Wait, no, you spoke! You lost!
Brock, wait, give me one more chance.
No, bro, I'm sorry, you lost. That's not how it works.
Security.
Wait, what? No, wait, okay, okay, I'll give you another chance.
Sorry, you're gonna buy me something?
Yeah, I guess.
All right, bet, let's go to Dior.
Wait, what? This is where you want to go?
Yeah, Dior.
All right, let's go. How do those feel?
Pretty good. How much are these?
$11.50.
Okay.
Bruh.
Thank you, Topper.
Thank you.
All right, Jack. Here you go.
Thank you. Yo, follow Topper. I appreciate it.
Yeah, of course.
These are the best chips, and if you disagree, you're wrong. This or that?
Bruh.
This. This or that? I love onion rings.
Bruh.
This. This or that? Anybody else eat their chips this way?
Bruh.
This. This or that? These are way better than the other Doritos. Bruh. This or that? It's hot. This or that? Like the video if you think this should win, and subscribe if you think these should win. This or that?
This is an obvious one.
That. This or that?
Got this just in case I need it.
This or that?
Come to daddy.
Bruh.
I don't really like the sun, so this or that?
I've successfully been able to do insane things at millionaires' mansions by just asking. So today I am going to be
asking millionaires if I can watch a movie inside their mansion.
Hello? Can I watch a movie in your house?
Get off my lawn!
After many of attempts,
no way. No, go away.
I was becoming extremely frustrated that nobody was letting me try out my new 3D glasses. But I wasn't going to give up.
Can I watch a movie in your house, maybe?
This seemed impossible, just like it's impossible to like and subscribe at the same time, until I came across this.
Jack? Can I watch a movie inside your mansion?
Sure, let's go.
Jack Doherty's house is worth over $15 million, with multiple stories, a massive pool, and then he showed me the movie theater.
Alright, you can watch anything you want, on me.
This was perfect. Time to enjoy this movie.
Is it possible to draw a dotted circle?
I doubt it, but I'm not gonna stop until my dotted circle looks like this. My first attempt looked like this.
An eggplant.
Bruh.
Just like it's impossible to draw a dotted circle, it's impossible to like and subscribe at the same time. After trying every way I could think of to draw a perfect dotted circle, and I mean literally every way,
Bruh.
It still wasn't looking good. So I did my research and saw
it's all in the pressure.
I had to apply the perfect amount of pressure and rotate my arm like a clock. This was actually so close. Before I mastered my dotted circle, I had to challenge my friend. So I showed them the technique, and we got to work. Brandon tried. Tori tried. Joe tried.
What? What is that? That looks like the dirty bubble.
Shutters was so close. But finally, I won. Today, I got amazing news.
Chipotle is now giving golden burritos from their secret menu if you have a Chipotle burrito tattoo.
And this got me thinking. I've been able to fake my way into getting a free Subway for Life card and a $10,000 golden burger. So this should be a piece of cake. The plan was simple. I reached out to a professional body paint artist, explained to her exactly what I wanted, and paid her $10,000 for this realistic burrito tattoo. Then I found the nearest Chipotle, and it was
was time for the test. I waited nervously in line until it was my turn and asked,
I heard that if I have a Chipotle burrito tattoo like this one right here, I get a golden burrito. Is that true?
I was terrified while I was waiting. She was bringing out the manager to see if this was true. They then went to the back and came out with a special golden bag. And no way! It's a golden burrito!
How many free things can I get on my birthday?
First stop, Dunkin' Donuts. Since it's my birthday, can I get a free donut?
Sure.
This is awesome.
Whatever I get for free, I will be giving back to the community. Up next, I headed to Starbucks.
Today is my birthday. Can I get a free drink?
I was getting birthday wishes all day. Now on to our next location. I went over to Chipotle and they gave me free chips and guac. And even Domino's gave me a free pizza. And just when I thought I couldn't get any more free stuff.
Bro, what if?
Should I ask?
You have to.
I saw a Lamborghini.
Since it's my birthday, can I take a ride in your Lamborghini?
Sure.
No way it actually worked. We can't be friends anymore. Let me explain. I love soda, but my best friend Shutters is always telling me,
bro, water is so much better because it's healthier.
So today we're gonna see which one is better. Let's see how hard I can punch after drinking soda. Help! Ah! Level 2 speed test. Team Water, let's go!
2,000 years later.
That took you forever!
Team Soda!
Woo! Bro, that was so fast!
Let's go! Level 3 fashion show. Subscribe if you think soda's better, and like if you think water's better.
This is my best friend Shutters, and he doesn't like Prime because he thinks it tastes too sweet. He won't even try it.
So today, I'm gonna try and trick him into drinking Prime.
Idea 1, changing the name.
Yo, Shutters, I got you this new drink called Prime.
What?
Bro, it's so good. Try it.
Wait.
That's Prime! I don't want that.
Idea 2, swap it out for his mouthwash.
Here we go.
What? He's not brushing his teeth?
Idea 3, bribe him.
My friend Shutters loves subscribers more than anything.
Shutters! Topper, I'm not trying Prime.
If you try Prime, everybody watching will subscribe.
Fine, but only if everyone watching subscribes.
Guys, please!
If I make this, I get a PS5.
What?
Come on! Oh, let's go! If I make this, I get Topper's Diamond Play Button.
Wait, no, what? No.
Yes, let's go! If I make this, I get $10,000.
No way, come on.
Rick!
Bro, no.
Easy.
Oh, what?
Oh my God.
How did he make that?
What?
If I make this, I get Iron Man's helmet.
Wait, where'd you get that from?
Let's go!
What?
Oh my God!
Whoa! If I make this, I get a golden prime!
Let's see!
Let's
go!
Bruh. What? Are we looking at the same hoop?
I just got scammed. Let me explain. I have every single flavor of Prime except for Ice Pop. So I went to every store around me and it was sold out everywhere. I didn't know what to do until I saw this.
Collect all 7 Dragon Balls and you get one wish.
So I knew what I had to do. Find all 7 Dragon Balls, and if I do, my wish will come true. It was almost impossible to find these balls. Just like it's impossible to like and subscribe at the same time. I finally found all 7. Let's do this.
What is your one wish?
Could I please have 1 ice pop?
Very well. Go home and check your toilet.
Okay.
So I rushed home as quickly as I could and
no!
I didn't say Prime ice pop. This is my best friend Shutters, and he never drinks water because he only likes to drink sweet drinks. I even tried buying him the most expensive water in the world, and he still won't drink it.
So today I'm gonna trick him into drinking water.
I had to do my research, so I started with asking my dogs for some advice. Then I had to spend hours and hours searching online for some ideas. And finally, it hit me.
Would you rather drink water or watermelon juice?
Watermelon juice,
Daddy. Okay, go for it.
Bro, that's fire!
What?
I can't believe I was able to do this. Ever since I was a kid, I've always wanted to win at this game, but I never could because my aim was so bad. So I did my research and ordered the best water blasters in order to perfect my technique. The X-Shot Water Fast Fill allows you to refill in 1 second, so I had countless of attempts to master this. Then I figured it out. It's all in the aim. So after I almost perfected it, I had to challenge my friends.
Okay, stop.
I gave them each a different X-Shot water blaster with epic skins that look better than ever. Then I showed them all the technique, and now let's see who gets the closest. Shutters tried. Brandon tried. Tori tried. And finally,
Bullseye!
I won! Now I never miss at the carnival. And this was the worst celebration ever. The other day, I decided to throw myself a 16 million subscriber party. I started by making these invitations and mailing them out to all my friends. And then I went to the store to get all my favorite decorations for the party. This was gonna be lit. I needed everything to be perfect. Once I purchased all the decorations, I rented out the largest mansion I could find for my epic party. And then I started setting up. Everything was coming together so nicely. Now it was just time to wait for all my friends to show up and join the party. They had to be here any second. 3 hours went by and I was starting to rethink if anyone actually likes me. And I was starting to feel hopeless until my best friend showed up.
Loser!
And that's why. Who can get to the $10,000 without getting hit? Gorilla, dinosaur, or banana? All players have to be careful because the X-Shot Skins Griefer has enough power to hit multiple targets up to 90 feet away.
To start, I'm using the all-new Sharp Skin Blaster. Go T-Rex!
Their new air pocket darts go further, faster, and are even more accurate.
Oh, let's go!
X-Shot's incredible printing technology makes these skins all incredible.
Now I'm using my favorite blaster, the Apocalypse.
All right, Banana, go for it!
The X-Shot Skins Griefer range comes in 6 different epic skins.
Bruh.
Yo, he got so close!
Go, Gorilla!
Where is he?
Choose different, choose X-Shot skins. This morning, I was woken up with terrible news.
Bro, get up. You got a dentist appointment in 30 minutes.
Why this was so terrible? During my last dentist visit, I promised my dentist I would floss every day. But I haven't flossed once. I knew what I had to do. Then, I ran out of time.
Hurry up, you're gonna be late.
From getting dressed to the waiting room, I was beyond nervous.
Popper, we're ready for you.
I followed him to my room and sat down, knowing I was a liar.
Hey, Topper. Ready for your checkup?
I can't do this. I have to tell him.
So have you been flossing? Like you promised?
Of course, Dr. Gabe. I'm ready.
Okay, let's take a peek.
I was in too deep and didn't have the guts to tell him. And in just a few seconds...
How could you?
Doctor, it's not what it looks like!
You should leave.
The lesson today, never forget to floss. He isn't my friend anymore. Let me explain. My friend Shutters just bought a new pair of white shoes, and he is in love with them. He'll do anything in his power to keep them clean.
Steven, what are you doing?
Cleaning my shoes.
With my plaque?
Bro, my shoes are more important.
Bruh. Shutters has taken this too far. I need to do something about it.
So I destroyed his shoes using the world's darkest paint.
Time to show him his surprise.
Shutters, I have a surprise for you.
Have you ever wondered how much money it would cost to buy every single gumball in a gumball machine? Well, luckily, I have nothing better to do. So I'm gonna figure this out for everybody. Besides, how long could it take? I started in a great rhythm, quarter after quarter, making great progress. And before I knew it, I already had 20 gumballs. But after doing the same thing over and over, this became exhausting. I realized I was going to be here a while, but I wasn't going down. And after hours of hard work, I figured out it cost $189 and 50 cents for an entire gumball machine.
100 pin bowling challenge. Let's do this.
Oh,
52.
53.
Ow.
Pineapple doesn't belong on pizza.
Yeah, it does. What are you saying? 51.
I saw that.
Easy 100.
No.
Wait, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Oh. Oh. 21.
What are you doing? You have to pick those up.
Trick shot. Take two.
the LeBron James of bowling.
Oh, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Oh, 91, baby.
My play button's better.
No, my play button is better.
This is my best friend Shutters, and he thinks his play button is the best. But I think mine is way better.
So today we're gonna find out whose play button is better. Level 1, drop test.
Okay.
See, mine's completely indestructible.
How? My turn. Yo, I don't want to drop it. I don't want it to break.
That's because yours is weak.
Level 2, size. Mine's the perfect size. It can even fit in my pocket.
Lame.
I love mine because it's big and it changes colors. Whoa!
How does it do that?
Level 3, whose can swim better?
Okay. Look at him swim.
Okay, my turn. Mine can't swim.
And finally, subscribe if you think my play button's better. And like if you think mine's better.
Cats are better.
No, dogs are better.
This is my best friend Shutters, and he loves dogs. But I think cats are way better.
So today we're gonna figure out which one is better. Level 1, who listens better?
Sit. Sit, boy. Roll over.
Sit, kitty. Sit, kitty, kitty. Level 2, who is cuter?
Marshmallow is the cutest thing in the entire world. Way cuter than some cats. Isn't that right, buddy?
Nothing's cuter than this.
Who's the good kitty?
Level 3, who is more loving?
He's so loving. It doesn't get any more loving than this.
Oh my gosh, listen to him purr. And finally, like if you think cats are better.
And subscribe if you think dogs are better.
I'm gonna take this notebook into a 5-star celebrity restaurant and act like a food critic to see if they treat me any differently. They sat me down immediately and had water waiting for me. Right away, I took out the notebook for the waiter to see and started my critiquing process.
Bruh.
I think it was working because I was getting pointed out by their staff. I then placed my order.
May I please do the chicken milanese?
And
they brought out the food so fast.
It has to be because of the notebook. I have never tasted anything this delicious before in my entire life. Does it always taste like this? Or is it because I have the notebook?
I think I see the manager talking to the chef.
I started taking detailed notes and was about to ask for the check until the manager walked up to me and said this.
We have a surprise for you.
You have a surprise for me?
Our famous lobster golden pizza.
I couldn't believe my eyes. And then they sent out every single dessert on the menu. After this incredible meal, the waiter dropped off the check and it was completely free. He is obsessed with these. This is my best friend Shutters, and he loves donuts.
Yo, Shutters, why don't we get some food?
Bro, I have food right here. Why would I ever leave?
What?
But lately, he's been super sad because all he wants is a giant donut. So I did some research and found the perfect surprise for him.
$100,000 for a giant donut.
A giant donut? What do I need money for?
Bruh. 1 million subscribers or giant donut?
Giant donut? I don't even have a YouTube channel.
PS5 or giant donut?
Giant donut. I can't eat a PS5.
Bruh. Okay, come with me. Okay, Shutters, here you go.
This isn't a giant donut.
Okay, Steven, the only way I'll give you the giant donut is if everybody watching likes and subscribes in the next 3 seconds.
Guys, please subscribe.
Oh, look at it.
Oh my God, this is huge.
These changed my life. We all know Crocs have 2 modes, chillin' mode and sports mode. And I'm always running late, so that got me thinking, can putting my Crocs into sport mode actually give me a speed boost? Well, I guess it's time to find out. So I grabbed my favorite Crocs and headed to the nearest speed testing location. After stretching and warming up for a bit, it was time to put these Crocs to the test. I started with my Crocs in chillin' mode. My first couple attempts ended Croc-less, but I figured out how to keep them on and finished 100 meters in about 15 seconds. Now it's time for what we've been waiting for, sports mode. Instantly, I felt weightless. I finished 100 meters in 12 seconds. That's way fast. Have you ever wondered what would happen if you walked up to a millionaire's mansion and asked to sleep over?
Look at that kid on TikTok that wastes food.
No.
After 10 hours and almost getting in,
me puedo dormir en tu casa.
We still couldn't get a yes until this house.
I've actually seen quite a few of your videos.
Really?
Yeah, quite a few.
Do you mind if I sleep over here?
Come on in.
This place was incredible. It had a volleyball court, a golf course, and if that wasn't already cool enough, they had a water slide. The owners were so nice and even gave me the master bedroom to sleep. My friend Holy keeps stealing all my prime, but every time I ask him about it, he says this.
Hey!
That's my prime! What are you doing?
Nothing, bro. What are you talking
about? That's mine!
I need to catch him red-handed because there's no way he's telling the truth. The plan? To booby-trap my prime stash and hire my friend to pie holy next time he attempts to steal my sacred drink. But when I went to drink some prime after my workout, my friend thought I was holy and accidentally pied me in the face.
Bro!
So sorry.
Wrong person!
Bruh. Time for phase two. The instructions were simple. To sit and record. Nothing could go wrong. Until I watched the footage myself and saw this. I now know that I cannot trust anyone.
What happened to my prime?
Time for phase three. To sit there myself. Only one problem. I fell asleep after sitting there for hours, and Holy ended up taking all my prime. So when I woke up, all of it was gone.
No! No, my prime!
Today I'm gonna get something free from Costco. I have multiple disguises that I'm going to use to see how many free samples I can get before getting kicked out.
One per person?
Mm-hmm. We'll see about that. I started with my first disguise. And?
Howdy there, sir.
Bruh. Thank you.
Very good. This drink looks gnarly. Can I take one?
Bruh.
That's already two samples and I'm just getting started. Three, four, they had no clue it was still me. So I went to a nearby aisle and changed my disguise once again. This was going shockingly well. But after doing this so many times, the employees were starting to get suspicious. Bruh. If this works, everybody has to subscribe. And I got my last sample because I was out of costume. This is why I'm a genius. Let me explain. Today I'm going to try and get free snacks inside of a movie theater. The plan? To fake my girlfriend's pregnancy. Bruh. My first step was to buy a hollow bowl and fill it up with our favorite candy. Then I had to tape it to her body to make sure nobody would notice. This was 100% going to work. And now for the moment of truth. We bought the tickets and it totally worked. This was the best movie ever. Today I'm gonna figure out how many licks it takes to finish a jawbreaker. Honestly, this took me weeks to work on. My tongue feels like it's about to fall off. But I wasn't going to give up. I've already found out the answers to some of the most commonly asked questions a human has. Like how many tablespoons it takes to fill a bathtub, how many Doritos it takes to fill a bathtub, and how many licks it takes to finish a lollipop. There is no way the jawbreaker is gonna defeat me. And after putting my tongue through absolute torture, it took me exactly
56,302.
I can't believe I found this on his phone. Let me explain. My boyfriend Topper's been acting suspicious, so as soon as he set his phone down, I went to go see what was on it. After going through it, I saw this.
Do you want BJ's?
On my way! So he is cheating on me.
As soon as he hugged me goodbye, I slipped an AirTag into his pocket to track him. I went to his location and saw that he was just at the restaurant BJ's eating with his grandpa.
Bruh.
Oh, that makes sense. But I still felt a little off. So I waited for his location to update, and it was at
Wendy's?
He's at another girl's house. I'm gonna have a word with this Wendy. But when I got there, he was just at the restaurant getting dessert. As I started to realize I'm being overly protective, his location updated to the park. He never goes outside, so this was super weird. As I was watching him, a note fell out of his pocket. It read,
"Dear Annie, I am so sorry, but I have terrible news to confess. If everybody watching likes and subscribes, I'll tell you the truth."
Like and subscribe!
Mr. Beast scammed me. Yesterday, I ordered a Mr. Beast burger like I do every day. But this time, I noticed something was off. There was only one pickle on my burger. There's no way this could be right. The menu clearly says pickles with an S, meaning more than one pickle. Mr. Beast was running a scam. Bruh. Jimmy is better than that. It had to have been a mistake. So I ordered another burger and I couldn't believe my eyes. One pickle again. Since this is clearly a scam, I was left with one option, to sue Mr. Beast. Bruh. So I began writing a formal letter to Jimmy. I then flew the letter over to Jimmy and awaited my reply. Weeks were passing and I hadn't received anything yet. I decided it was time to confront Mr. Beast face to face. So I FaceTimed him and all he did was tell me it was a simple prank.
Do not talk into the phone and I'll buy you whatever you want for Christmas. What's your name?
All right, you win. Okay, now you can talk. What's your name? I'll buy you whatever you want.
You can speak now, I promise.
Swear?
You just spoke.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, come on. Anywhere you want to go, I'll buy you anything you want. This way? Okay.
Anything you want.
Anything?
Anything.
I'm definitely gonna need some second opinions.
What do you
think?
Wow.
What do
you
think?
Is that the last one? Okay.
The last one.
That one's really good too.
It's pretty, right?
Yeah.
It's pretty. I feel like a first date is like kind of cute, right?
Yeah, it would. Okay, here you go.
You're amazing. Thank you. Text me.
Bye.
Play with us. Whoever blinks loses. Level easy.
It's hurting.
I'm out. I gotta stay in.
If you made it to level medium, drop a like.
Easy.
Easy, Blink Topper, Blink. Easy.
I'm gonna win.
If you made it to level hard, leave a comment.
What a Blink so bad.
How many wood boards can me and Zong punch through? That's one.
Hey, yeah!
Like it's nothing. Three boards.
Oh! There's no way.
Ow! Five boards.
Here we go. Wait, I'm a friend. Hey, come here.
Like the video if you think I'm gonna win, and subscribe if you think they're gonna win.
Subscribe!
Ben Azalar and I have beef. Let me explain. I checked my mail and saw that YouTube sent me my diamond play button. But when I read the back, it said,
Ben Azalar?
They sent me the wrong one. Bruh. So I went to Ben's house to tell him that YouTube made a big mistake.
Ben, look, YouTube sent me
the wrong
one. And that's when this happened. So we both called YouTube and they said,
they said they won't give me another one until I pass you in subscribers.
That's not gonna happen.
Bruh. I had to do whatever it would take. My first idea was to buy a Hollywood tour bus and drive all around LA telling people to
subscribe to Topper Girl.
After driving around for hours, my subscriber growth was still slow. I'm not gonna pass Ben at this rate. So I needed to go to my favorite place on earth to cheer me up. And then it hit me. I made a deal with the
What happens when you bring a pony inside a pet-friendly hotel?
I was just wondering if I could get a room for tonight.
What was that? Like a donkey?
No, it's my dog.
Bruh.
No?
Unfortunately, they denied pony, but that wasn't gonna stop me. So we went to the next pet-friendly hotel.
Hi there. I was just wondering if we could get a room for tonight. We saw you guys were pet-friendly, so.
For how many nights?
Just one night.
It was working. Pony was so excited. Until this.
So that means that she wouldn't be allowed?
Oh, Tula.
Pony was crushed. So I had to give her a cookie to keep her spirits high and positive for our next hotel. We went in confidently and asked,
do we have a room for tonight?
Unfortunately, they said no too. Someone is stealing from me. Let me explain. The other day I bought four primes and left a note for nobody to drink them. When I went back to the fridge to grab one, I noticed there was only three. Someone is stealing from me. So I decided to go on watch outside the fridge. But I fell asleep. And when I checked, there was only two left. So I followed a trail of prime I found to my friend Shutters' room. And when I asked him, he said,
it was Brendan!
I only drink toilet water.
Is this a scam? Chick-fil-A milkshakes are my favorite, but I can't afford one every day. So I'm going to make my own milkshake to prove you don't need to spend all that money. All I needed was strawberry ice cream and milk for only $8. With these ingredients, I can make at least 8 milkshakes. But the question still remains, which shake is better? I went to the nearest Chick-fil-A to find out. I ordered a milkshake and asked for an extra cup to disguise my personal There's no way this is true. Why does every toothpaste commercial say,
number one brand recommended by dentists?
There's a million dentist recommended toothpaste. How can we trust them? Today, my goal is simple. To walk into every single dentist office I can find and find out which is truly the most dentist recommended toothpaste.
Sensodyne, okay.
This was going pretty well so far. I went dentist to dentist to dentist and received different responses.
What toothpaste do I get?
After hours of traveling, I ran out of dentists in Los Angeles. So of course I took to the streets to get some more data. I asked people in the toothpaste sections of stores.
Hi, what type of toothpaste?
As you guys know, I refuse to waste anything. Bruh. So instead of squeezing harder than I do on the toilet, just to get the tiniest little drop of toothpaste, I bought some toothpaste squeezers. This first one kind of looked like Shrek, and it was difficult to place the toothpaste into. But I had hope it would save the day. As the little Shrek was squeezing, I realized that there was still some toothpaste in there, and it wasn't working as I hoped it would. This next one looked even more promising. It seemed as if it would give the vacuum effect that I was looking for. But as I tried to get it set up, it broke. Luckily, I saved the best for last. This one was the most expensive and the most durable. And it was making the most progress. I've been able to swim inside millionaires' pools by just asking. So today I'm going to take it a level up and ask billionaires if I can swim in their pools. I had to get inside a gated community and...
Hi, I'm here to see billionaire Elon Musk.
It actually worked! Time to start asking.
Hi, can I please swim in your mansion?
Nope.
Hi, can I swim in your mansion?
Wait, aren't you Topper killed?
Yeah!
No.
This was harder than I thought, but I wasn't going to give up.
Hi, can I please swim here?
No, Tuck is ugly.
Everything changed when this happened.
Hi there, can I please swim in your pool?
The gate opened and there was security at the door. This is Jack Doherty, a 20-year-old billionaire living in a $50 million mansion in Beverly Hills, California. He has security with him everywhere he goes. This was a bad idea. I decided I'd ask Starbucks to make me the most disgusting drink possible. I pulled up to the drive-thru nervously and asked,
I would just like the most disgusting drink you think you can make me.
Are you being serious? 100%
serious. I want it nasty.
Bruh.
What is this?
Okay, so I made it as disgusting as I can. I mixed everything that's in here.
It doesn't look so bad.
It looks delicious.
I mean, yeah. I also added all the inclusions.
She wrote... Good luck on it! On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the most-
Go! Okay, oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Okay, the tie, okay. Two more pops first! Oh my gosh! Dylan to the lead! Oh, come on! Oh no! Oh no, Topper! Don't get left behind! Oh my gosh! Go! Oh my god! Okay, let's go!
Ruined my life. Let me explain. As you guys saw, I recently got my new play button, but then this happened, and YouTube said,
they said the only way they'll give me a new one is if I pass song and subscribers.
Wait, Sean, what are you doing?
Nothing, I'm just playing with my ball.
Bruh. Well, since you broke my play button, you have to get me a new one, or I'm gonna tell your girlfriend what you did.
Okay.
First, Zong tried live streaming to his 29 million subscribers, telling people to,
guys, I need everybody to go subscribe to Topper Guild.
Next, he opened a kissing booth offering,
how long does it take to bake cookies in a hot car?
Today it is blistering hot and over 100 degrees outside. So I knew I had to test this out. Now we just sit in the car and wait.
How much longer?
It's barely been an hour and the cookies look like this and I look like this.
They're not even done cooking. What do we do to make the car hotter?
I have an idea.
This isn't gonna work!
After another 2 hours went by, the temperature in my car was only rising. And then it hit me. I don't even have to be in the car to see them cook. I was so hot that I started to hallucinate.
Subscribe to Topper.
Oh! No!
This was unbelievable. My dad and I have always loved ice cream sandwiches. And today we're gonna find out the difference between the lowest and highest rated ice cream sandwiches. We started off with the lowest rated one. It was described as awful and even multiple reviews saying that they would never eat this again. These were horrible. Definitely a 1 out of 10. And my dad's stomach agreed. So I headed to a famous spot So today, I was in the bathroom and I went to wash my hands. I began to wash them aggressively because they felt super nasty. And now they were super soaking wet. So I went to dry them and saw this. This made no sense to me. Bruh. Who would do such a thing? I looked in the trash to see if I could find something to dry my hands with. But there was nothing. I was extremely frustrated. But then thought, could I be getting pranked? I instantly started looking around the bathroom for hidden cameras and found a very angry old man. Once again, so sorry about that, sir. Bruh. But this wasn't going to stop me from getting my hands dry. I had an idea. The Flappy Bird technique. Still wet. But then it hit me. I instantly started drying my hands.
All right, Topper, guess the drink.
Let's go. That would taste like an S Baked Sugar.
I don't know.
I'm gonna say Coke Zero for this one right here.
Okay.
Next. Pepsi for sure. Okay, I'm gonna say this one's Pepsi. Next one. Why is this one hard to suck? Is it like a shake?
Bruh.
Mayo!
You didn't read it?
No, I didn't read the text!
Okay, let me wash it down.
This is a real-life flying ghost that flies using a drone. And today, we are gonna scare people with it and get their reaction. First, we went to the park and saw some kids playing basketball. So we had to get them.
Oh my gosh, oh my-
Now we're about to prank my mom. And last, we scared my friend who was walking by the store.
Oh my gosh.
Bro, it's not even
me cheating. Let me explain. My goal this year was to eat healthier, but I am always caught cheating on my diet. So today, my best friend Shutters is going to help me.
Topper, are you cheating on your diet?
No, this broccoli's so good.
Topper, are you lying to me?
I just love burgers so much.
I will only let you have a burger if you do what I say.
Okay.
No, first you have to play with my ball.
Okay.
Bro, this is so hard.
That's the point.
Bruh.
Next, you have to do my homework.
No!
Topper, I got an F. Who spells cow? K-O-W.
Isn't that how you spell it?
Bruh. The only way you'll get your burger is everyone watching likes and subscribes.
Guys, please like and subscribe.
Okay, Topper, you can have one burger.
Okay, here it comes.
Bruh. What? That's cheating.
No, it's not.
The world record for the longest kiss is 58 hours. And today, we're gonna break that.
Since I finally have a girlfriend, I was ready to take on this challenge and become the next world record holder. Everything was going perfect until we got hungry. It then became very obvious there was no way to drive and go get food like this. So we had our friend give us a ride. It was a little awkward, but we managed to get through it. We got to the restaurant and then ordered. But then we faced our next obstacle. How can we eat? So we just got a milkshake instead. So after this, we decided to go to the mall and do some shopping. And everybody and they mama was staring at us. And after walking around for what felt like forever, I got a call from my friends. They really wanted to go ice skating, and my girlfriend wasn't too happy about that. So I promised her I would get her some flowers after. Which probably wasn't the best idea. Today I'm gonna find out if a candle really does burn for 40 hours. This one started off easy. I mean, after all, I just had to light the candle and wait. Little did I know, after a few hours went by, I started to bond with the candle. His name is Jimmy. Yes, I named him. In order to pass the time, we started doing some bonding activities, like making eggs, painting pictures of each other, and just spending quality time together. After a long day, I decided it was nap time. And after we woke up, we got ready for dinner at my favorite restaurant. But then, the following day came. I knew Jimmy's time wasn't much longer on this earth. The label said he only burns for 40 hours. It started to hit me. I was going to lose my best friend. His flame was looking faint, and that's when I heard it. Jimmy burned for over 50 hours. So I guess candles really do burn for that long. And it shows, yeah, yeah, yeah. 'Cause you make me feel like I've been locked out of heaven. For too long, for too long. Yeah, you make me feel like I've been locked out of heaven. This was a dumb idea. Today my goal is simple: to break the law and get arrested. Why? Because the other day I saw the most beautiful girl to walk this earth, and she was a police officer. Obviously I asked for her number.
It's 911.
But there's no way I was gonna give up just yet. And that's when I realized the only way she was gonna give me the time of day was if I got arrested. I waited for her to check me out and jaywalked over to her.
I just jaywalked. Time to arrest me.
Arrest for jaywalking, but here's a ticket.
It was time to step up my game even more. It's illegal to park within 10 feet of a fire hydrant, so I made my next move.
No, looks like you still have space.
Are you serious?
I have to figure this out. So as I was drinking water, I purposely littered. Yes, yes, it's totally working.
I'm gonna need some backup.
Backup?
Hey, 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 what are you doing? No, no, I picked it up.
And that is why.
If I told you this was only gonna hurt, if I warned you that the fire's gonna burn, would you walk in? Would you let me do it first? Do it all in the name of love. Would you let me lead you even when you're blind?
This might be my worst idea yet. Let me explain. I'm going to trick a cop into doing something illegal. In order to do this, first we need to find a law for a cop to break.
There!
It's illegal to cross the street without using the crosswalk. My plan? Find a parked cop car.
Right there!
Then set up a free donut stand across the street.
Come and get them, nice and fresh.
All that was left was to wait for the cops to do the unimaginable. The nearest crosswalk was over 500 feet away. I couldn't believe my eyes.
Oh my gosh, they're coming, they're coming, they're coming.
Oh my gosh, they're breaking the law. Yes!
You're under arrest.
For what? I'm a cop. Bruh.
For jaywalking, come on. Walk, tell it to the judge.
I don't feel anything. Where is he? Oh, 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 my God, I feel it, I feel it, I feel it. Oh my gosh, it's getting heavy! Is that all of it? Okay, here I come, baby! Here I come! Oh! I'm coming! Oh my... Get it? Oh!
Did I get it?
I don't know! It's all on me! Yes, go, go! Oh!
Oh! Is it in? Is it in?
What happened?
Wait, is that it?
Did you get it?
I think it went on me.
I never thought this was possible. Ever since I was a kid, I've always wanted to dunk, but I've never been tall enough to. And that's when I got an idea to do some research and find out the secret to running faster and jumping higher. And that's when I found these shoes called Jumpman. Bruh. I had to get my hands on a pair. Luckily, I found them at a shoe store close by and paid $10,000 for them. They even had this guy dunking on them. Bruh. It was time to put them on and start stretching because there is a myth that stretching makes you taller. Let me tell you, some of these stretches were not easy. I think I pulled a hammy on that one. Bruh. It was now time to put the Jumpmans to the test. So I ran at the hoop with my full force, jumped, and...
Oh, let's go!
Today I'm gonna figure out how many licks it takes to finish a lollipop. Ever since I was a kid, I wondered what this answer would be. So I got right to work. This started easy and actually quite enjoyable. But after a few hours, my tongue was in extreme pain. But I wasn't giving up. This took me weeks and some of the most extreme mental willpower and determination. I licked, licked, and licked, and even licked some more. To find out, it takes exactly
47,302.
This was the biggest surprise of his life. My friend Shutters loves Barbie and really wants to go see the Barbie movie. But when he went to go get tickets, they were all sold out and he got really sad.
So today I'm gonna be a good friend and surprise him with a Barbie dream house.
Yo, Shutters!
Yeah?
Do you want your own Barbie dream house?
Yes, please, I'll do anything!
Anything?
Yeah?
First, you have to play with Ken's balls.
I can do that.
But why are these so heavy?
You're almost done. Alright, come with me. Second, you have to clean the house.
Okay.
Wow, Steven, you're really good at this.
Bruh. Thanks.
Okay, Steven, the only way you can see the Barbie dream house is if everyone watching likes and subscribes.
Guys, like and subscribe, please.
Okay, put this on. Are you ready to see the Barbie dream house?
Yes, yes.
Okay, look.
I thought you were taking me to a real Barbie dream house.
You still know.
Bruh. How many layers of bubble wrap does it take to stop a human being?
Oh, that's one! My dad is the test subject today. Let's see if he can get through two layers.
Yeah, let's go!
Oh my god!
Oh, too easy!
Five layers!
Oh, he got it!
We now have 10 layers. You're gonna need some protection for this one.
I don't think this is a good idea, Sean!
Go for it!
Oh! Oh, he got it! Let's go!
20 layers, Dad. You think you got it?
You got me, Sean! Go for it!
Oh, he's going!
Oreo roulette!
Oh, oh, oh!
Oh! Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh!
No.
Oh!
No.
Oh!
No.
Oh! 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 Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh my gosh, ew!
Oh. Let's go, let's go, let's go!
No, 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 no! No, ew. No! No.
This is my new best friend, Zong, and we've been doing everything together. We even play with each other's balls.
You're so good with your hands, bro.
So are you.
We've been having the best time ever, but we have a feeling Nick is getting jealous.
Yo, guys, can I play with you?
No, bro, we already started.
Sorry, bro.
We even saw this. So Zong and I came up with a surprise to make him feel better.
Wait, what's that? Can I open it?
Only if everybody watching likes and subscribes.
Yo, please, guys, come on.
Okay, here you go.
Oh. Wait, check the closet.
Okay, come with us. Okay, Nick, here you go.
I'm so excited. Wait, what's this?
That's your new best friend.
Why can't I just hang out with you guys?
Oh, we gotta go to a movie.
Bruh.
Bye, Nick.
We'll see you later. Bye.
Are you serious right now? It's just you and me, buddy.
Hey, yeah. I can't believe this happened to me. The other day, I was at the park when I saw the cutest squirrel, and I needed to take a photo of it. As I reached for my phone, it fell out of my pocket right through the storm drain. I couldn't believe my eyes. I was crushed, but then realized I had to get my phone out of the drain. Bruh. So I had to use my resources, my gum and my shoelace. Bruh. As I tried to get the phone, the gum wasn't sticky enough, and the shoelace wasn't sturdy enough. Bruh. So I needed to find some stronger support. Attempt number two. The stick. stick. After carefully lowering the now more so chewed gum, the stick wasn't long enough. So now for my final attempt, finding a $5,000 magnet off the internet in hopes of getting my phone back. After I met up with the guy and got the magnet, I lowered it down and...
I got it! I got it!
It was totally working!
Oh, let's go!
I did it! But then realized that the magnet completely wiped the phone and it doesn't work anymore.
Bruh.
I'm about to sneak into Disneyland. Let me explain. As you guys saw, I got banned from Disneyland because I put a Subscribe to Topper Guild banner across the Disneyland castle. I was able to reach 20 million subscribers because of it, but being banned wasn't going to stop me from gaining more. So I snuck in, ditched my disguise, and started by buying every single balloon at the park and handing them out in exchange for a subscribe. This was going perfectly until this happened. Bruh. So then I put up banners all around the park telling people to subscribe to Topper Guild. But nobody noticed them. I was really disappointed until it hit me. I had to put a banner up at Disneyland where everybody could see it. Subscribe to help me hit 25 million subscribers. The other day, I found out that if you put a ring of salt around a Tesla, it makes the car temporarily unable to drive. And that left me with the idea of finding a random Tesla owner to test this theory on. And luckily for me, there was a Tesla parked right next to me. I found my target. So I patiently waited for him to get out of his car and walk away from it. It was go time. We had a small window of time to get this done before he came back to his frozen Tesla. Once we finished placing all the salt, it was time to wait in the car and get his reaction. After waiting over 2 hours,
oh my gosh, he's coming, he's coming, he's right there.
He was finally coming back to the Tesla. I've never seen anybody so confused.
Oh my gosh, yo, he's going to the car. It's not gonna work, it's not gonna work.
He's literally not gonna be able to drive.
Wait, what? It doesn't work?
Today I am going to find out what happens when you ask a millionaire to swim in their pool. And...
Hi there, can I please swim in your pool?
No.
That didn't work, but I wasn't going to stop there.
Can I swim in the pool?
No.
Bruh. As we galloped to other houses, I was starting to get extremely frustrated because nobody was saying yes. Until this happened.
Is it okay if I swim in your pool?
Yeah, you look pretty cool.
Really?
Yeah.
Thanks, bro.
This house was epic. It had its own elevator, movie theater, bouncy house, and even a see-through pool. I was finally able to swim. Did I just create the best Prime flavor? Since I drink Prime and nothing else, I really think I understand the drink better than anyone. And I know exactly which flavor they are missing. So I came up with a genius plan. I gathered the ingredients I needed and perfected the flavor. This is busting. Now it's time to design it. So I got the darkest black paint known to mankind and gave this Prime the most beautiful design ever. Just like it's hard to design this Prime, it's also hard to like and subscribe at the same time. It is now finished and time to reveal the final product. I call it
Meta Moon.
How big am I? I'm actually 5'10", and today we're gonna find out how many bottles of Prime it takes to reach my height.
One bottle.
This tower was already getting tall. I wonder how many it's gonna take.
5 bottles. 6 bottles.
From the top.
Bruh. 7 bottles. How is this staying?
This tower is getting tall.
I'm still taller than it. Hurry up, it's falling. Okay. 10 bottles. Oh. Oh! It's hard! No! No! 3, 2, 1, go! Wow, Holy! Oh my gosh, dude, you're so good at this! Whoa! Do you think you can do that blindfolded?
Oh, well, of course.
For sure? Alright, here, throw this on. 3, 2, 1, go! Oh my gosh, Holy, you're so good at this? Dude, how is it not hitting you? Oh my gosh, that was close, that was close! All right, ready? I'm gonna hit it. Go faster, go faster, go! Holy, go! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Okay, bro, you're good.
Yo, dude, take off your blindfold. That was insane.
She said yes. This is Annie, and I've been talking to her for a couple of months now and decided today was the day I was going to ask her the big question. People make it their mission to take the craziest photos on Splash Mountain, and today I was going to become one of those people. I planned this for weeks in advance with my friends and even practiced at home to get the timing right. The day came where me and my friends were going to make this a day she would never forget. I had the surprise in my backpack all day, and Annie had no idea what was about to happen. We had Annie sit in the front, so there is no way that she could possibly see what we were doing behind her. The time came for the big drop. We had everything set, and I was hoping that the wind and water didn't ruin my surprise. I rushed her to view the photo before it went off the screen, and I asked, "Will you be my girlfriend?" She was completely shocked, and
don't steal, don't cheat, no lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in.
Mr. Beast and Jake Paul? Mr. Beast and Logan Paul.
Let's go!
Arak and...
No, Arak and David Dobrik? Yes!
Oh wait, they look familiar.
Zong and Ben Aslar?
Cover Gills and Zong.
Wait, what?
Ryan Trahan and Ben Aslar.
Let's go!
Subscribe if you think I'm gonna get the next one right.
And like the video if you think that I am.
Who is that? Brett Rivera and Unspeakable?
No!
Brett Rivera and Destiny.
What?
Oh,
this is an oxygen bottle, which I bought for $20. I thought oxygen was free. Whatever. Bruh. Today we're gonna find out if it's actually useful by doing as many push-ups as I possibly can in 60 seconds. I began by starting the timer and doing as many push-ups as possible without any extra oxygen supply and gone.
32.
Push-ups done. Now it's time to see if this thing actually works.
Oxygen time.
I started my timer and used the oxygen as needed. Would this improve my performance?
Gotta keep going.
I was exhausted, but able to keep going. My 60 seconds were up, and I got...
84!
He's really jealous of me. Let me explain. This is my friend Shutters, and he's always been super jealous of my mustache. He's been trying to grow one for months, but there's nothing there.
So today, I'm gonna get rid of his.
I'll give you $10,000 if I can shave your mustache.
No way, bro. I look too beautiful.
Nothing was going to get rid of my beautiful mustache. But then he did the unimaginable. Waited until I fell asleep and did the deed.
Please subscribe!
The other day I was wondering, what actually happens to your poop after you flush it? Well, I have nothing better to do, so let's find out. I started by grabbing an air tag and making an apple smoothie. Get it? Anyways, I drank the smoothie and waited until it was time. This air tag was about to embark on a journey it did not know was possible. It was now time to track it. This thing was traveling way faster than I expected.
It has to be moving through the pipes or something.
I followed it around LA until I ended up here. And just as I was about to give up, I realized it never left my body. I was tracking myself all day. I flew on the worst rated airline in the world. Online, there are thousands of reviews of flyers absolutely hating it, saying the plane was filthy, the flight attendants had terrible attitudes, and there was even horrible turbulence. Once I got on the plane, I noticed it looked damaged, and it was super uncomfortable and hot. So I tried the AC, and it was broken. When I got to my seat, I saw a huge mess that wasn't even mine. And the grossest thing ever, a piece of chewed up gum with hair in it. I went to the bathroom and realized they had no toilet paper.
There's actually no way.
Can you keep it down?
The good news, the flight is over. The bad news, they lost my bag. This was the worst day of my life. Today I woke up super hungry and then thought, Chick-fil-A sounds fire. So I got out of bed, put my shoes on, and quickly ran to Chick-fil-A. I was so excited and then realized, Chick-fil-A is closed on Sundays. I was so devastated and never wanted anybody else to feel like this. So I knew what I had to do. I waited until Chick-fil-A was opened again and then went up to order and said,
can I please do one of everything on the menu?
I was ready to open my very own secret Chick-fil-A. There was gonna be no hungry customers on this Sunday. So I camped out until it was the next Sunday and got to work. I set up the table, grabbed all the Chick-fil-A, and I even had my own custom Chick-fil-A uniforms. Within seconds, we already had customers. We even had a guy who wanted our drive-thru.
Have a good one, okay?
How much do I owe you?
It's free today. You're good. We'll see you later.
This is awesome!
And even a dog. This was the best Sunday ever.
Time to guess the YouTuber product. Are you ready?
Let's go!
Alright, Topper, which one is Hershey's and which one is Feastables?
Alright, hold on, let me try this one first. Definitely Hershey's, 1,000,000%.
No peeking?
I can't see, I'm not peeking. That one has the Feastables texture. 1,000,000%, that's Feastables.
Alright, Topper, which one is Prime and which one is Gatorade?
Alright, first one, here we go. Woo! That one is sweet. Next, Prime?
Okay, Topper, which one is marinara sauce and which one is pizza feet?
That one's definitely pizza feet. It tastes exactly like Arak.
Hey, yo. Bruh. Which one is McDonald's and which one is Beast Burger?
All right, here we go. Ooh, this one's light. Okay. Is there any water around here?
What's up?
Oh! Beast Burger?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Yes or no?
Yes. Wait, snakes?
Can I have a kiss, buddy?
Yes or no?
Yes.
I get a dog.
I love dogs.
Yes or no?
No. Wait, a Lamborghini?
Yes or no?
Yes.
A warhead pickle?
How sour can this be?
Rainbow power!
Yes or no?
Yes. Oh, balls! I love balls. My favorite.
Yes or no?
No.
What's your challenge? That was a close one.
I have a massive crush on this girl named Hannah. And last week, I tried to be smooth with her.
So, do you ever think we'll be more than friends?
Yeah, Topper. If the world was ending.
I was devastated. But then that got me thinking. What if I convinced her that the world was actually ending? So that I could finally date the girl of my dreams. The first part of the plan was to invite her over.
Hey, bestie.
Once we were on the couch, I turned on the TV, and it was time for the moment I had been waiting for. So, I gave my friend the green light.
Command has detected the launch of 12 nuclear missiles aimed towards the mainland United States.
The world is ending?
What should we do?
Bruh. It was totally working! How could this plan possibly go wrong? Until...
Wait, what?
The video ended.
You said it was the only way!
I can't believe Disneyland sells this. Today I'm going to be trying the worst foods at Disneyland. Starting with this spicy chili cheese churro. It's safe to say this looks disgusting. And it was. Bruh. Up next we have...
Hi, can I just please do Darth Vader's biscuit with the dip, please?
The drink looked super weird, and the biscuit looked and smelled like it had mold on it. And let's just say it wasn't my favorite. So then I asked...
Hi, can I please do one bucket of the pirate chum, please?
I hope this one's better than it sounds. They brought it out, and this one was mixed. Decently surprised. Anyways, moving on. We have one of Disneyland's most controversial snacks.
Hi, can I please do one pickle dog?
They finally gave it to me and gave me some peanut butter to dip it in. And...
Hey, this is pretty good.
Today I'm gonna be busting mints at the world's most expensive theme park.
So for this first one, in Harry Potter World, we all know about their famous butter beer. But if you ask for the...
Can I please do one Ruby Wizard?
Thank you so much.
They bring this out.
Oh my gosh, dude, no way.
Myth confirmed. Next, in Simpsons Land, I heard that you can trade a massive donut to one of the workers and they'll let you cut the line.
Is that true?
Yes, thank you so much.
Myth confirmed. I couldn't even believe this final one. In Jurassic World, there is a myth that all the dinosaurs on the ride are made of real dinosaur bones. So I had to ask a worker.
That is possible.
So yeah.
Myth confirmed. I had to be the first person to try this.
Stone Bricks Pizza is now giving a golden pizza from their secret menu if you have a pizza tattoo.
So I knew what I had to do. I have successfully been able to get a golden burrito from Chipotle and a golden Big Mac from McDonald's. So now it's time to see if I can successfully get a free golden slice of pizza from David Dobrik's Pizza Restaurant. To do this, I had to reach out to a professional body paint artist and explain to her exactly what I wanted. It took hours to paint this slice of pizza onto my stomach, and we had multiple distractions along the way. After what felt like an eternity, the pizza was done and it was time to pay the body paint artist. Then I rushed over to Dobrik's and waited until it was my turn and asked,
I heard that if I have a Dobrik's pizza tattoo like this, I get a free slice of golden pizza. Is that true?
I then nervously waited until they called my name, and it worked! It's a golden slice of pizza!
Hello?
This was the worst thing that's ever happened to me. The other day, a very suspicious package arrived at my doorstep. And when I opened it, there was this adorable doll.
Hi, I'm Chucky.
I instantly knew that he was going to become my new best friend. We did everything together, and I mean everything. He even told everybody to
subscribe.
But when I woke up the next day, Chucky was missing.
Chucky?
I ran downstairs to find the entire house destroyed, and there was Chucky. A doll couldn't do this. I put him in timeout and headed to go get some coffee. But as soon as I sat down in the car, I saw this.
I'm your friend to the end.
This was getting weird. All week, I felt like I was being watched. Bruh. So I was left with only one option. To throw him away to get rid of him permanently. Finally, some peace and quiet. Today I found a sign for a missing dog named Nibbles with a $50,000 reward. And I had to do whatever it would take to get the 50, Bruh. I mean return the dog to its rightful owner. So I went to the first place a dog would run away to, the dog toy store. But Nibbles was nowhere to be seen. I then realized I was moving too slow and headed to his last known location, the dog park. Upon arriving, I realized this was going to be much harder than I had expected. I made a few trips around the park and carefully observed each dog, but still no Nibbles. I was starting to give up until I found this. A note with Nibbles' name on it, on the back of a Dobrik's pizza receipt. So I went to Dobrik's and found another dog that wasn't Nibbles. I was getting discouraged, but wasn't ready to give up until I received a notification that Nibbles was found 3 years ago, and I wasted my entire day. I hope nobody notices. I was able to fake my way into getting service at a restaurant wearing no shirt and then no pants. So today, I'm gonna see if I can get service
with no shirt and no pants
at the same time. Bruh. I called a professional body paint artist and she told me what I needed to do in order to pull this off. Standing there for hours was really hard. Just like it's hard to like and subscribe at the same time. But after 10 hours and $20,000 later, it really looked like I was wearing clothes. Let's see if this actually works. So far, so good. I sat down and almost nobody noticed that my clothes were painted on. Some people even complimented my outfit. Bruh. It worked! How long does it take for your phone to die? Sometimes I feel like I just unplug it and it's instantly dead. So today I'm gonna figure out what's draining my battery so quickly. I have two phones at 100%. One of them will just be left on and the other one I will use until it's completely drained. I started by turning on my flashlight and opening every app. I even played Subway Surfers to see if it would drain faster. And after an hour, the phone was at 81% and the other one was still at 100%. Then I decided to play my favorite song to see how it would affect my battery life. Then I FaceTimed my friend, and he told me it was impossible to like and subscribe at the same time. And just like that, the phone was almost dead after 9 hours, while the other phone was still almost completely charged. I guess being on your phone really does affect your battery life. We have to get to the bottom of this. Let me explain. I love Mr. Beast bars, but my best friend Shudders says,
bro, Hershey's are so much better. So today, we're gonna see which one is better.
Test number one, strength. Test number two, taste test.
These both suck.
What?
Test number three, size test.
Bro, yours is 7 inches. Yours is gonna be way smaller, watch. Bro, yours was only 4 inches. That's so small.
That's not that small.
Subscribe if you think Feastables is better.
And like the buddy if you think Hershey's is better.
He won't stop drinking this. Prime just announced their new lemonade flavor. And my friend Steven is absolutely obsessed with Prime. But when he went to order the new flavor online, it sold out within 5 seconds. And that's the only thing he wanted for his birthday. So I made it my mission to find him the rarest Prime in the world. But it was looking impossible. Just like it's impossible to like and subscribe at the same time. Luckily, I found the new flavor online and paid $10,000 for one bottle to surprise him. Then I went into his room and showed him his birthday present.
Shudders, Shudders.
And to say he was excited was an understatement. Bruh. He then got ready to drink his Prime like he always does. Bruh. And this was his reaction.
Best birthday ever!
What happens when you bring a horse to a dog groomer?
Hey, I want to get my dog groomed.
They brought out the entire team and even the manager to debate this request.
I don't, it's because
think they're certified.
But as I suspected, they rejected me. Pony was so crushed after being rejected that she wouldn't even have her favorite drink from Starbucks. So we went to the next pet groomer. And after another debate, Pony was defeated. We galloped confidently to our next groomer, the most fancy pet spa in LA, called Groom Dog Care with Love. So I walked up and asked,
I'm looking to get my dog groomed.
What's the name?
This is Tulo. She's a big girl.
Okay, let me get the groomer.
It's time for the moment of truth.
So would you be open to grooming Tulo? Really?
It actually worked! Pony loved her bath, her haircut, and even her new French braid with the bow. I flew on the world's most expensive airplane seat that cost more than $100,000. The inside was amazing, and my seat was huge. They had 2 flat screen TVs, a salon with everything you need, and even a snack basket. Once it was time to order food, they handed me a menu with some delicious options.
May I please do the steak, eggs, and an iced tea, please?
While waiting, I checked out the bathroom and found this.
I'm literally taking a shower on the plane.
The food was then delivered by the nicest flight attendants, and I even saw,
I see the pilots eating sushi.
Sushi. After dinner, I was given a pillow and a blanket and decided to sleep the rest of the flight. The only downside? I'm down 100K. Don't talk into the mic and I'll buy you whatever you want. Wait, Jack Doherty? Oh gosh. Okay, how old are you? I like your shirt, man. Alright, okay, fine, you won.
I know I won. This is literally my idea. You're copying me.
Bruh.
Okay, well, bro, you're just gonna buy me whatever I want.
This was not looking good. Jack was walking towards all the most expensive stores.
I think I need something more expensive.
How do you even get more expensive than this?
Trust me, I know a spot.
Oh no. Until he brought me here.
This place is gonna be too expensive.
Bro, you owe me a lot.
Bro, I have not made that much money off of doing the same videos as you to come here. Bro.
I have never been more scared in my entire life.
This one is 43,400.
Perfect. 100K on my wrist right now. Let's get them both.
You get one, Jack.
Alright, I'll pick the $62,000 one.
Okay, whatever you want.
I can't believe I actually just did that.
Dude, this is so far. You can copy my videos anytime now.
I just got banned from Disneyland. Let me explain. As you guys know, I am trying to reach 20 million subscribers, and I have tried some absolutely crazy things to do so. Disneyland's maximum capacity is 5 million people, and strange enough, that's how many subscribers I am away from 20 million. So I knew what I had to do. I went to Disneyland with all my friends, and we all wore shirts telling people to subscribe to Topper Guild, but that wasn't working. So I tried to get more attention by yelling,
"Subscribe to Topper Guild!"
But the subscriber growth was still too slow. I was starting to give up, but then it hit me. I put subscribe to Topper Guild where everybody at Disneyland could see it. It was working. I was gaining thousands of subscribers a minute until this happened. They kicked me out and the day has finally come. As you guys saw, Ben Azalar broke my diamond play button. And YouTube said the only way they would give me a new one is if I passed him in subscribers. Well, I did some crazy things to gain subscribers and finally passed him. And that's when this happened. YouTube was here to hand deliver my new play button.
I finally got it back.
This thing is my baby and I'm not letting anybody touch it. I even took it somewhere where we could get some alone time. I was so excited, I decided to show my new best friends, Zong and Nick. But then this happened.
Not again!
So I called YouTube and they said,
they said the only way they'll give me a new one is if I pass Song and subscribers!
Subscribe to help me get my new play button. This is my best idea yet. IHOP has a rule where after 4 p.m., kids eat for free. So I did the only logical thing. I disguised myself as a baby to see if it was possible to eat for free.
Do they look sus? No, they completely believe it.
Really?
I made sure to stay in character the entire time. There is no way they are going to catch me. This was actually kinda nice. Wait, here comes the food. It worked! It was now time to get the check to see if we really pulled it off.
And then, was the kids' meal taken off?
Yeah.
You'll be able to see it says, -9.7.
There's no...
This is my best friend Shutters, and he is obsessed with X-Shot's Hyper Gel Blasters. So today I'm going to surprise him with every single X-Shot Hyper Gel Blaster.
Yo, Shutters!
What's up?
Do you want every single new X-Shot Hyper Gel Blaster?
Oh, yes, please, I'll do anything!
First, you have to give back to the community!
Bro, that's easy, let's go!
Next, you have to take out the trash.
Okay, bro, anything. Okay, what's next?
Come with me.
Third, you have to hit the X with the
X-Shot Hypergel Clutch Blaster.
Yes, bro. Give me.
Let's go.
If he wins, he gets all three of these.
Okay, whenever you're ready.
The Trace Fire and HPG 700 blasters are motorized with great power, and the epic size makes it easy to hold. He can have so many tries because of the pellet capacity. He can also hit every target from anywhere using any of these three gel blasters.
I got it right here.
Because of their epic distance and accuracy.
Oh, yeah! Give me the blasters! Let's go! Best day ever!
This happens every time. My shoes always get creased, and it's impossible to uncrease them. It was time to say goodbye to my old creased shoes, and time to buy some brand new ones. My goal? Survive a whole day without creasing my shoes. I started off by putting a ton of socks on to better fill out the shoes. I couldn't walk like a normal person, so I had to do the duck walk. Then came my first major obstacle, the escalator. Once I safely made it up, my legs were hurting, so I had the idea to call my strongest friend and have him carry me around. But apparently he was not as strong as I thought. Bruh. I tried everything I could to not crease my shoes, besides my final move, the roly-poly. It was working. I survived the whole day without creasing my shoes, but I had not anticipated my sleepwalking. How could I have been so dumb? I guess my sleepwalking explains why I'm so jacked. Bruh. I then woke up overcome with joy to see my beautiful...
I failed.
This was so weird. This is called a miracle berry. And when consumed, it temporarily changes your taste buds so that sour tastes sweet.
So today we're trying it out with the least sour to the most sour foods in the world.
After taking this miracle berry, these candies should turn out sweet. Up first, we have the green apple.
No way! This tastes like straight sugar.
Food number two,
the lime.
This tastes so sweet, it's still working!
Food number three.
Extreme sour warheads. I got this. It literally tastes like candy!
Bruh. And now for our last food item. The most sour of them all.
Toxic waste.
He just got the best news of his life. Let me explain. This is my friend Shutters, and he is obsessed with X-Shot blasters. And today, I showed him this.
Are there the new X-Shot Insanity blasters?
Yes, and I'll get you all of them, but you have to listen to me.
Okay.
First, you have to hit these targets using the Manic and Berserko blasters.
I got this.
Let's go, Shutters. Oh, this one, next blaster. Oh!
Too easy, what's next?
Second, you have to hit this moving target using the Mad Mega Barrel and Motorized Rage Fire, which is X-Shot's first motorized blaster that comes with its all 360 tripod.
3, 2, 1, go!
Oh, there we go! On to the next!
The speed, accuracy, distance, the power are amazing on all four of these blasters.
All right, Shutters, I'll give you all the blasters, but you have to hit all types of targets within 10 seconds.
Piece of cake, bro, I got this.
Let's go!
Yes!
Yeah!
Here you go, Shutters!
This is awesome!
Oh, bro, I just shot the chicken in there!
Bro, there's no way!
Yeah, you wanna bet?
$100.
Okay, $100, let's do it! Right there. I told you!
Bro, it's not real, you tricked me!
That was the deal!
Bro, no, another one!
I bet I can finish my cereal before you can finish your cereal!
Bro, no way, cereal's my favorite!
Alright, $100!
$100!
Ready, go! Done!
How? One more!
Final bet! I bet you $500 I can make you say the word subscribe!
Bro, I'm never gonna say it.
Okay, what color is the sky?
Blue.
Okay, what color is my shirt?
Pink.
Okay, what should everybody do that's watching right now?
Like.
Oh, you said it!
I said like, not subscribe!
This is Disneyland.
And this is Universal.
The two most famous and popular amusement parks in the world. And today my goal is simple, to start some beef.
I heard that Universal's better than Disneyland. Do you guys think that's true?
They can try as hard as they want. They're never gonna beat us.
The beef has begun.
I heard that Universal makes better drinks than Disneyland. Is that true?
No, we make the best.
Disneyland had some words to say about Universal, and their confidence was peaking.
This is gonna be hard to compete with.
Universal wasn't happy about that.
I don't care, I think we are better.
So Universal's better?
Absolutely. Wow.
They had their own opinions on Disneyland.
Drink-wise, honestly, Universal actually has some great drinks.
Yeah?
I would also say they're more decently priced than Disneyland.
This has gone way past the small beef I was trying to start.
Disneyland says that they're way better than Universal. Is that true?
Never.
Do you guys think that's true?
Bruh.
What have I done? Which park do you think is better?
Spaghetti! Spaghetti sauce! Perfect!
And it shows. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Cause you make
me feel like I've been locked out of heaven for too long, for too long. Yeah, you make me feel like I've been locked out of heaven.
One,
two,
three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12.
He just made the worst decision of his life. Let me explain. This is my favorite YouTube play button that YouTube gave to me when I got my first subscriber. And today when I woke up to give it its morning kiss, it was gone! So I checked my security cameras and saw that my best friend Shudders traded it for some mac and cheese!
Bruh. Shudders, how can you do this to me?
Because mac and cheese is fire. You want some?
No! Bruh.
So I started to look for ideas to get revenge on my friend. Idea one, pranking him.
Oh! Wait, Steven, how'd you know?
No, what?
Idea two, taking something of his.
Give me your guitar!
My guitar, no! Well, it's a good thing I have an extra guitar.
Bruh.
Wait, Tupper, are you still upset?
I don't have my play button anymore!
Don't worry, everyone watching will like and subscribe to make you feel better.
Guys, please like and subscribe!
According to the internet, it is impossible to tear a sheet of paper more than 7 times. Challenge accepted. I grabbed the paper, studied it, reminded it who it was messing with, and got to work. After the first few tears, I was getting pretty confident I could tear this more than 7 times. But suddenly, the paper decided to toughen up and wasn't budging easily. I was giving it everything I had. I wasn't gonna let the paper beat me. So I picked things up a notch. And after the strength the Spider-Man mask gave me, I defeated it! How many balloons does it take to make an iPhone float? Well, I guess more than one. 3? No. 6? No. 10? Not even close. Maybe 15 will do the job.
15 balloons.
Boy, I was wrong. At this point, I was unsure if this was even possible. I increased the amounts of balloons by increments of 5.
25. This has to work.
Bro.
Oh, 30 balloons.
Oh my gosh.
I was determined to find out how many balloons this would take.
35 balloons. Here we go. Oh my gosh.
Oh, wait. Oh no, it's going down.
50 balloons. Oh
wait,
my gosh.
Wait.
Yo, it's
me. Let's go! Let's go! I think I can go!
How many wood boards can me and my dad get through?
Bruh.
That's one. Yeah! Too easy! 2 boards! Yeah!
Bruh.
4 boards!
Yeah!
Bruh. Yeah! 7 boards! Ooh! Yo, this is getting harder! Ooh! I did that better than you!
Bruh.
10 boards. 12 boards.
Alright.
Ah! Oh, let's go! Ah! For the win! Yeah, let's go!
Starbucks always gets people's names wrong, so today we're putting that to the test. I went into the Starbucks and the worker asked me this.
Perfect, what's your name?
Topper. As I waited for my drink, I thought there was no way they were gonna spell my name wrong. Timmy? Like Timmy Neutron? I thought maybe it was just this location, so I tried another Starbucks. This time giving them a name they couldn't possibly mess up.
Yes, Eric?
E-R-I-C. Eric? Like the YouTuber?
Bruh.
This has to be some sort of joke. I started to lose hope standing outside my third Starbucks. But this time, I got an idea. I was gonna give them the hardest name I could possibly think of.
Joaquin.
And now for the moment of truth. They spelled it right!
How many pumps does it take to finish a bottle of soap?
Well, lucky for you guys, my schedule wasn't looking too busy. So we're gonna find out. I knew this challenge might take weeks or even months. So I named our new little guy, Calvin. Calvin and I were gonna do everything together. We started by cleaning my table, which then led me to cleaning my phone and even my car. That one kinda took a while.
Bruh.
I knew Calvin wasn't gonna survive until Halloween. So I got our costume early this year. Don't we look great?
Bruh.
After Calvin wrote me a sweet note, it was time to wash my hands from all the crazy work today. It took exactly 452 pumps to finish the bottle of soap. So there's a bunch of secret Disneyland myths, and today we're gonna bust all of them.
There is a myth that Disneyland has special air vents that smell like desserts in order to make people hungry and buy their food. So we sniffed around and found this.
Dude, this literally smells like cotton candy.
Myth confirmed. There is a myth that Disney has a basketball court inside Matterhorn Mountain. So I found an employee and had to ask.
Is that true?
That is true.
Really? There's actually one in there?
Yeah.
The next myth is that if you give a Disneyland employee a churro, they'll let you cut the line.
If I give you this churro, can I cut to the front of this line?
I'm sorry, I can't, man.
No? Okay, well, myth busted, but at least I got a churro.
My boyfriend doesn't love me anymore. Let me explain. This is my boyfriend Topper, and he loves his subscribers. But recently, his subscriber growth has been slow, so he's been really sad. He loves his subscribers more than he loves me, and I was thinking how I could make him happy again. And then it hit me. I need to get him more subscribers. First, I had to make some money so I could buy more phones to subscribe to him. Next, I stood on the road with a giant sign telling people to subscribe to him. But he was still gaining subscribers super slow. Guys, I need your help. Subscribe so Topper can be happy again.
What happens when you leave a car covered in money in public?
I have no idea, but today we're gonna figure it out.
We started by covering my Tesla in dollar bills one by one. This was taking way too long. After 4 hours, it was finally time to place the last dollar bill. Now it's time to see how people react. But there was just one problem. We still had to drive the car into public. We could risk losing all the money on the way there. So this left us with no choice but to send it. Bruh. Everyone was staring. I knew that once we got to the spot, it would be absolute craziness. We parked and instantly people started taking money. We were losing dollar bills by the second. The car was getting swarmed. Even a kid took some. It was time to move to our next location. This spot was even crazier. The car went from being completely covered to almost empty within seconds until the security guard rolled up. Luckily, I was able to bribe him with some of the $1 bills. Hundreds of people had taken money off this car, and before I knew it, all the money was gone.
I just took the biggest risk of my life. This year, I got a Coachella ticket, but didn't have a place to stay. So my plan, just like I've done successfully before, I'll be asking millionaires at Coachella if I can stay with them. Hi, can I stay with you just for Coachella?
No.
Bruh. This was brutal because it was so hot outside.
No.
I was now wondering once again if the word yes even still existed.
No, absolutely not.
Until this house.
Can I stay with you for Coachella weekend? Is that a yes?
I think so.
Bruh. Voldemort's house was actually very nice. And there was lots of fun activities to do. It had a basketball court, a golf course, it even had a pool. Shout out Voldemort, because this was the best weekend ever. This is how you get free donuts from Krispy Kreme. The other day, I saw that for every A you have on your report card, you get a free donut from Krispy Kreme. There's just a few problems. I haven't been a student in over 5 years, and I don't look like a kid anymore. Well, that was kind of an easy fix. Bruh. After that, I did the obvious. Paid $10,000 to re-enroll in school, took 6 months worth of classes, and got A's in all of them. I then printed out my report card and headed to the nearest Krispy Kreme. I excitedly waited in line and asked.
I heard that if I have straight A's on a report card, I get as many free donuts as I do with the A's. Is that true?
They brought out the manager to review the report card. And it actually worked! So this bowl of ice cream costs $5? $50? Today, my goal is to create the world's largest ice cream. This was going to be expensive. I started with my favorite flavor, oyster cream.
Bruh.
Growing up, my parents never let me get the flavors I wanted. So it was time to go off. The ice cream supply felt endless. I kept going and going and going, trying to perfect my swirl technique.
Yogurtland, you hiring?
Bruh. This was getting out of hand. Now time for the best part, the toppings. This sundae ended up costing over $100. The other day, I had the world's most expensive gold steak. And this got me thinking, is there actually a difference between the most expensive steak and a $1 steak? Well, today I'm gonna find out. I ran over to the nearest steak restaurant and brought my $1 with me. I scanned the menu and quickly found out that the cheapest steak was over $1,000. I contemplated giving up on this challenge, but then remembered, I have nothing better to do.
Bruh.
So I went to the 99 cent store and found my $1 steak. I then got home and put it in the microwave. As I waited for it, I had to mentally prepare by doing yoga and becoming at peace. Was this steak gonna taste like absolute garbage? Or was it gonna be as good as that gold steak I just had? One way to find out. The steak was now ready, and now for the moment we've all been waiting for. This was amazing! This is the best day of the year.
Customers can visit their favorite 7-Eleven and come with their own cup to receive any Slurpee for just $1.99.
Slurpees are my favorite thing in the entire world. Bruh. So I knew what I had to do. Buy the biggest cup I could possibly find and go to 7-Eleven to get my lifetime supply of Slurpees. As soon as we got into the store, the employee came up to us and said,
"No question, is it gonna leak on my floor?"
"No, it's not gonna leak, I promise."
It was time to get filled. Bruh. This was so crazy that even the 7-Eleven employees were taking pictures of us. Filling the bathtub was taking a while, but luckily some random people decided to help us. And after filling it up for literally over an hour, it was time to pay.
How much is it?
$2.18.
Perfect.
So I carried the tub, loaded it into the truck, and brought it home for all my friends to enjoy.
What is it? Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh, what is it? What is it? Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Oh! Let's go! Oh, what is it? What is it? Oh, it's empty! Last one! Oh, what is it? Oh, pizza!
Oh! So I was scrolling on my phone and saw all my friends were doing such cool stuff over the weekend. Like traveling, partying, driving supercars, and even meeting their favorite YouTubers.
Bruh. Missing out on everything.
My problem? I don't have friends. Bruh. I didn't get a single text this weekend, and I was bored out of my mind. I knew what I had to do. Make everybody jealous. So I rented a Hollywood movie set to fool people into thinking I was taking a private jet across the world.
All right, bro, get off me. Get off me.
Then I set up a green screen so I could convince people that I landed in Paris.
Just made it to Paris, guys! Yeah!
My plan was totally working. Everyone was believing I was cool. This was the best day ever. Even my dad called me.
"Hey, Dad,
are you in Paris?"
Yeah, I just got here. It's incredible.
"That's funny because your location says you're home."
And just like that, my plan fell apart. My phone started blowing up. Everyone knew I was a fraud. What I learned? I will never be cool. Have you ever wondered what would happen if you set off every single alarm in the Apple Store? Well, today, we're gonna find out. I started by playing it cool and gaining their trust, but this was taking forever. So I had my friend Steven distract them while I went to every single device in the Apple Store and set the alarms for all the exact same time. I was becoming very nervous, so I had to do something calming.
Bruh.
It was now showtime.
The alarms are about to go off.
The alarms were going off in 3, 2, 1. People in the store had no idea what was going on. And the employees were so confused. And that's when I got caught. Mr. Beast sent me this mystery box. The other day, my doorbell rang, and I opened the door to find this mysterious safe sitting outside my house. Clearly sent from Mr. Beast himself. What could be inside? I needed to find out. I tried throwing the safe, hammering the safe, using a drill to try and get it open, but still no luck.
Ah!
I will stop at nothing to find out. When all of a sudden, the doorbell rang, and this time there was a key outside my house, with a note attached to it that read,
"Sorry, forgot to give you the key, signed Mr. Beast."
But the key was bent! What am I- Oh. There's another one. So I used the key and opened it. At first, there was nothing interesting inside, but then I came across these notes. "Here are the pickles, because I was a few pickles short on my last Mr. Beast burgers." And the second note read, "Call me." I called Mr. Beast, and he just told me how cool he thought I was. This was so frustrating. About a month ago, Ben Aslar broke my diamond play button, and YouTube said,
"They said they won't give me another one until I pass you in subscribers."
That's not gonna happen.
Challenge accepted. So to gain more subscribers, I paid each of my friends to hand out flyers all around the city telling people to subscribe to Topper Guild. The plan was genius until I saw this. I guess I have to take matters into my own hands. So I went to a crowded part of town and told people to
subscribe to Topper Guild.
But nobody even looked. I was done messing around. I knew what I had to do. Climb the Golden Gate Bridge and hang a banner telling people to subscribe to Topper Guild. Subscribe to help me pass Ben.
My boyfriend's acting suspicious. Let me explain. Every time I try to go into his room, he says this.
No, leave.
What could he be hiding? He has been guarding the door and won't leave no matter what I try.
I'll pay you $10,000 so I can go in your room.
No, wait, what's in my room is worth way more than $10,000. Get out, get out.
I can't believe he did that. Whatever he's hiding must be really sus. Could it be another girl? Then I got really sad, but I wasn't gonna give up. So I waited until he fell asleep and snuck in. The only thing I found was a note, and it read,
"Dear Annie, I'm sorry, but there is something I must tell you. The only way I will is if everyone watching likes and subscribes."
Like and subscribe!
I was having the best day ever until my phone died. I had no way to copy, create my contact. But then I realized I have this, a solar panel phone charger. Both my phone and the charger are dead, and the only way for me to get home is Uber. The sun is already charging it, but I need to get closer. Then I got an idea. I went to the nearest lifeguard tower as fast as I could, but it still wasn't charging fast enough. And then it hit me. I had to get as close to the sun as I possibly could. And now for the moment of truth. Oh my God! It's working!
Do not speak into the phone and I'll buy you whatever you want for Christmas. What's your name? Just real quick, can you just tell the camera your name just before we start? Please? Okay, you win. All right, whatever you want for Christmas, I'll buy you. Okay, so you're just not gonna talk? All right, let's go.
This place?
Okay, let's go. You're really not gonna tell me your size? You're gonna do it with your fingers? Don't answer me if you think everybody watching this should follow me.
Perfect, thank you so much.
Okay, here you go. Here are the shoes. Merry Christmas. Now that I bought you them, and like they're all yours and they're in your hands, you won the game. Can I know your name?
How many red cups do I weigh? More than one.
Two cups.
Yeah, we're gonna need way more.
Seven cups. Here we go.
Bro, this is never gonna work.
Nine cups.
Oh, it's getting close. It's getting there.
12 cups. Like the video if you think this is gonna hold me, and subscribe if you think I'm gonna have to keep going.
Oh! No! 16 cups! This one has to work!
Oh! 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 Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Breath.
20 cups!
Here we go!
Today I am going to
find out how many strokes it takes to finish a piece of chalk.
I have committed myself to finding the answers to useless information that nobody wants to know. You're welcome. I knew this was going to take all day, possibly all night, but that's okay. I have nothing else to do.
Bruh.
I chalked, chalked, and even chalked some more. I was so determined to get you guys this answer that I even ran out of room on my chalkboard and started chalking my door, my Xbox, and even my car. Just to find out, it takes exactly
11,382.
How does McDonald's Sprite taste so good? Today I'm gonna figure that out. I went into McDonald's to get my usual Sprite, but this time all the machines were blocked off. And that's when I saw they were watching me. They must have known I was investigating the case. Just like I know it's impossible to like and subscribe at the same time. So I walked up and ordered the Sprite, but they brought it out from the back. They must be hiding something back there. I just know it. So I asked,
is there any way I could pour my own soda in the back?
No, that one isn't working.
That didn't work either, so I headed home to test this myself. As I tried each variation of Sprite,
McDonald's is still better.
Until I saw it. The McDonald's straw is almost double the size of the regular straws, allowing for more carbonation and flavor for each sip.
It tastes the same!
Mystery solved. This is Prime, and this is Gatorade. Today we're gonna see which one of them will survive the highest drop. First, we have 1 foot. No damage done to either drink. Now we have 5 feet. The Gatorade already has a pretty big dent. And the Prime looks a little beat up, but definitely in better shape. Time for 10 feet. Gatorade this time actually looks pretty good. There's still a big dent, but the Prime bottle completely ripped. This is way closer than I thought it was going to be. Now time for the biggest drop of them all. 20 feet. We have our winner by knockout, Prime! I have to be the first person to get this.
Apple is rumored to be giving out golden iPhones to anyone with an iPhone tattoo.
I knew what I had to do. Call a professional body paint artist, explain exactly what I need done, and pay her $10,000 for this realistic iPhone tattoo. Then I found the nearest Apple store and was ready to put this to the test. If this actually works, everyone has to subscribe. They went to the back and came out with this. Inside the bag was a golden iPhone box. It's a golden iPhone! This iPhone was so cool! I think Apple should come out with this color.
How many layers of tinfoil can a human get through?
No shot!
One is nothing! Five!
Three!
Yeah!
Oh,
five was close, now we got 10! Now time for 20! Let's do this!
Oh! Whoa! That was close!
50 layers! I'm pretty nervous about this one! Let's do it!
Oh, whoa!
Bro, this is thick! 100 layers! Here goes nothing!
That counts!
Next, we have 1,000 layers of tinfoil. Oh boy, here we go! What is on?
My best friend Shudders only drinks Prime Lemonade. So today I'm going to see if he actually likes Prime Lemonade or if he's a phony. So I waited until he went to go play with his balls and made my move. I swapped his Prime Lemonade with regular lemonade I got from the store. Subscribe if you think he's going to notice. It was then time to put him to the test.
Shudders!
Okay, so I have Prime Lemonade and regular lemonade right next to it, okay? You're going to tell me which one you like better just based off of the taste.
That's too easy. I got this. All right, let's start with this wannabe prime.
Okay, go for it. How's it taste? How's it?
Bruh. Oh, that is not the way lemonade should taste like. We saved the best for last. Some prime. Bro, prime is the best. You cannot beat it.
Bro, you are such a phony.
This is a Starbucks, and around the corner is another Starbucks. Today, my goal is simple: to start some beef.
Hi there. Can I just have something really fun?
Starbucks A was taking this serious. They clearly didn't want to lose this battle. After patiently waiting, whatever they made me was definitely not on the menu. But let's see what Starbucks B has to say about that.
I'm gonna be totally honest with you. I was at another Starbucks down the street, and they told me that they can make a way better fun drink than you guys.
I got a bone to pick with them.
Yes, you do.
The beef has begun.
So you think that you can top them?
Oh, I know it.
Starbucks B had some beautiful color to it. Some might say the perfect shade of pink. But Starbucks A had quite the visual appeal. There can only be one winner. And I'm gonna have to go with Starbucks B.
Perfect.
This is the best gift ever. Let me explain. As you guys saw, YouTube sent me a note that told me if I hit 23 million subscribers within a month, then they would give me a special surprise. And I did it. Then I heard a knock at the door. I went to go check it out, and there it was. YouTube special surprise. So I brought it inside and opened it as quickly as I could. I found a brand new iPhone 15, a bowl of cereal, and a golden mystery box. So I opened it, and it was a custom subscribe sign. This couldn't get any better until I found another note. It read,
if you reach 25 million subscribers by the end of the month, we'll give you an even better surprise.
Subscribe!
Okay, here we go.
Is it ice cream?
You got it!
Yes, let's go!
Can I please do one soft serve ice cream?
Perfect. Thank you so much.
Appreciate it, bro.
Alright, let's see. Jellyfish?
No, not even close.
Oh, a burger!
You got it!
Yes, go!
One burger?
This is not a burger?
Yeah, it is! It's an astronaut burger!
A burger and a tube? That's disgusting!
I'll pay you $69 if you do it.
Bruh.
Okay, deal.
Wait, this is fire!
Bruh.
Oh gosh, this feels like poop. Is it poop?
No.
Oh, is it pie?
Yes!
Let's go! I love pie!
Bumper, are you ready?
Yeah, bro, I'm starving.
Okay, here comes it. 3, 2, 1.
I can't believe nobody noticed. I was able to fake my way into getting service at a restaurant wearing no shirt and no shoes.
Bruh.
So today, I'm gonna see if I can get service
with no pants.
Yup, you heard me right. Bruh. The plan was simple. I reached out to a professional body paint artist, and she gave me specific instructions to pull this off. After hours of being a professional mannequin, and $30,000 later, it really looked like I was wearing pants. Let's see if this works. So far, so good. I ate at the restaurant, and nobody noticed that my pants were painted on. It actually worked, and I had no problem.
I'm gonna take this notebook into a fancy restaurant and act like a food critic to see if they treat me any differently.
I made a reservation at a 5-star restaurant and kept a low profile for the first few minutes. They weren't paying much attention to me, so I brought out my secret weapon, the notebook.
The waiters are talking about me right now.
Since I took it out, they have not stopped checking on me.
How's everything tasting?
Okay, thank you.
The main dish that came out was their famous steak, and it was amazing. So of course I had to take my detailed notes. Once I asked for the check, the head chef and the manager came out with tons of complimentary desserts.
Is this stuff even on the menu?
This is special made for you?
After I had all of these amazing custom desserts, I opened the check and couldn't believe my eyes. The entire meal was free. Is Starbucks a scam?
My grandma and I love Frappuccinos,
but they're super expensive. So today, I'm gonna make a $1 Frappuccino to see if it's better than the average one at Starbucks. Let's get frappin'. Bruh. So first, I got the freshest milk I could find. Then I added chocolate syrup, some espresso, ice, and then some chocolate chips. And you can't forget, 1 pound sugar!
Perfect!
It's time to put it to the test. I took my grandma to Starbucks and told her we were gonna try their new Frappuccino. But in reality, I disguised my drink to look exactly like a Starbucks Frappuccino. It's time to see which one is better.
Which one's better?
Thanks.
My girlfriend Hannah has been acting really suspicious recently, and I think she might be cheating on me. So I am going to use this AirTag to track her. As the day went on, I paid attention to her location and then realized she was at another guy's house. I'm gonna have a word with this guy. Turns out, it was her grandpa's house. Oops. Bruh. But as I kept looking at where she was going, I still had a feeling that I couldn't trust her. As the day went on, her location changed to 5 guys? There is no way I am letting my girlfriend hang out with multiple boys. Once I got to the location, I realized it was just the restaurant. Bruh. But I still had a weird feeling. And that's when I saw she was headed to the park. So I had to see what was going on. And I saw her writing a letter. It had to be to her secret lover. And as she was leaving, she dropped the letter and didn't even notice. It was finally time to catch her. The letter read,
"Dear Topper, I'm so sorry, but I have terrible news to confess. If everyone watching likes and subscribes, I'll tell you the truth."
Today I'm gonna find out what's the most expensive thing in the dollar store.
I tried looking at the first few items I saw, but everything was $1.25. I thought this was the dollar store. As I continued my search, I found this. There's no way this was only a dollar. But it was. After a while, I was starting to question if I was seeing right. So I put on these glasses, and still everything was $1.25. Maybe they were hiding the expensive items in the back.
Hey.
That didn't go so well. So I decided to ask an employee, and she just told everybody to
subscribe.
And I even heard this.
There is no recording in the back of the store.
I need to hurry. I was starting to give up until I saw this. A $100 gift card. So I checked out because I just figured it out.
$100.
Woo! This was his dream come true. Let me explain. This is my best friend Shutters, and he loved vacations.
It's so hot in here. I wish I was at the beach.
So today I'm gonna be a good friend and surprise him with a vacation.
Shutters, you wanna go on vacation?
Yes, bro, please, I'll do anything.
Anything? First, you have to prank someone with this pie.
I know just the person.
Oh! Shutters, it's me!
You didn't say who I had to prank.
Bruh. Next, you have to wash my balls.
Again?
Bruh. Wow, Steven, you've gotten good at this.
Bro, what's next?
Lastly, everybody has to like and subscribe.
Guys, please like and subscribe.
Okay, Shutters, here's your vacation. A 1-star hotel in your bed.
Bruh.
What?
Today I received incredible news.
Dunkin' Donuts is now giving golden donuts from their secret menu if you have a donut tattoo.
My plan was simple. I called a professional body paint artist, showed her exactly what I wanted, and paid her $10,000 for this realistic donut looking tattoo. Then I found the closest Dunkin' Donuts, and it was time to see if this would actually work.
I heard that if I have a donut tattoo like this, I get a free golden donut. Is that true?
If this works, everyone has to subscribe. They called my number, and my order came in a special golden bag. And it's a golden donut! This is how you get a free burrito at Chipotle. I recently found out that if you order a bowl and ask for double of everything, they will give you enough food in that bowl for 2 whole burritos for only the price of 1. So today, I'm gonna put that to the test and see if that really is true. Once it was my turn, I ordered a bowl and 2 tortillas on the side. I then asked for both white and brown rice and half chicken and half steak. I proceeded to get double toppings on my bowl as well. Did ordering double of everything actually end up saving me more money? Well, it was time to get home and figure this out. And for the moment of truth, it totally did. This burrito was heavier than this 5-pound weight. I can't believe I saw this.
Logan Paul and KSI are rumored to be giving out golden primes to anyone that has a prime tattoo.
I knew what I had to do. Call a professional body paint artist, show her what I wanted painted on, and pay her $15,000 for this realistic prime bottle tattoo. Just like it's hard to pull this off, it's also hard to like and subscribe at the same time. After hours, it looks perfect. And it's time to call Logan Paul. He totally believed it. And he asked for my address. Then I heard this.
I excitedly opened the door
to find a golden custom-made Prime box.
I rushed inside to open it and found,
no way,
a golden Prime that tasted incredible.
Today I'm gonna figure out how many steps are on an escalator.
How many steps could there be?
100,000? 20 million?
I don't know, but I'm gonna figure it out.
Bruh. My first thought was to stand still and try and count the steps one by one as they were moving.
And that did not work.
I then tried walking up and down and counting, but every time I thought I had the answer, more steps would appear over and over again.
Bruh. This seemed endless,
but then it hit me.
If I put a piece of tape on the first step I count, I would know how many steps are on the escalator.
This was totally working.
The answer was near.
No!
I was about to give up.
I was crushed.
Until I thought of my best idea yet.
To Google it.
How many steps are in an escalator?
50.
Mystery solved.
Bruh.
I'm the first YouTuber to get their own official drink at Starbucks. The other day I ordered at Starbucks and they told me that this was my 10,000th drink order, which puts me in their top 100 customers in the world.
Perfect!
I've tried every syrup, every type of milk, every topping. I even call myself the Starbucks King. And I have confidence that this is the best drink ever. So I emailed Starbucks to see if they would give me my own drink on the menu. And after waiting what felt like forever, I got an email and it read,
"Dear Topper, we would love to give you your own drink at Starbucks, but you must have 20 million subscribers first."
Subscribe!
Stay with him! Come on, we got this. Go, 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 go! Come on! Almost!
Hot sauce! Red and black pepper! Jalapeno!
People dying when alone in their homes, God. And listen, people take their lives as just a joke now. And overseas got the bosses doing talks now. But we still got murder in the big towns of Ukraine. Help Ukraine. The bombs and the guns and the World War III. Could they only just stop and think about this? What are the messages they're teaching their young kids? Violence is the way to sort their problems out. Meanwhile, the soldiers in the streets getting gunned down.
How many pieces of saran wrap can a human get through? One is too easy. Five.
That is a unit.
Five was not that easy, and now we got 10. 15 layers. I don't know about this one.
Oh,
15 layers, take two. Give me that. White Maiden, let's go! 50 layers. Let's get it.
I'm about to break a world record.
This is one basketball. And this is 10.
The 10 ball 30 pointer.
This was my first attempt.
The balls weigh over 50 pounds and stand at over 8 feet tall. There's no way I could give up on this challenge. I was prepared to be here all day, all night, however long it would take. The one thing I knew is that I was going to be a world record holder. I don't care if I'm 80 by the time I'm done here. This was my 20th attempt. I kept trying and trying and trying. And on my last shot, if I make this, everyone has to subscribe.
Oh! No, that has to count!
Have you ever wondered what would happen if you walked up to a millionaire's mansion and asked them to swim in their pool?
I'm asking millionaires if I can swim in their pool.
I'm not a millionaire, I'm a billionaire.
This house won't work.
Bruh. After countless attempts,
can I swim in your pool?
No.
No.
Heck no.
I was starting to question if the word yes still existed.
Can I please swim in your pool?
No.
Even at the drive-thru.
No.
To make things even worse, it started pouring rain. I almost gave up. Bruh. Until this house.
Excuse me, wait. Jack? Topper? Can I swim in your pool?
I guess.
This is Jack, a 19-year-old who lives in a $10 million mansion in the Hollywood Hills. He even has a purple Lamborghini in his garage. After touring the house, I finally got to get into a millionaire's pool, and my mission was complete. I found these ridiculous coupons online and wanted to put them to the test starting at Starbucks.
I have a coupon that says if I give you a croc, I get 2 free Starbucks drinks. Is that true?
I have never seen that coupon.
You've never seen it?
That's a dirty croc too.
It's dirty?
This coupon could have actually worked if the crocs were brand new. Time to move on to our next store. Dunkin' Donuts.
Well, I have a coupon that says if I give you guys a free tire, then I get a free donut.
He had to show the coupon to the entire team. And it was totally valid. Now it's time for our final coupon. McDonald's.
I have a coupon that says if I give you a potato, I get french fries.
After the manager reviewed it, it totally worked. There's no way this is real. The other day I was enjoying my Starbucks, but then I saw this. A $500 coffee made by a robot in Japan. Being the coffee expert I am, I knew I had to try this right away. So I booked my flight and headed to the airport. After my 14-hour flight, I got off the plane and there it was. As soon as I placed my order, the robot got right to work. The technology was so advanced that it was working at lightning speed. It even told everybody to
subscribe.
And once it was done, it brought my drink to me. And this is amazing. Best coffee ever. Today, I am going to the worst-rated restaurant in my city. My goal is to leave a 5-star review for this 1-star restaurant. But the only rule is, I can't lie. Seeing the 1-star reviews online, or the police helicopter circling the building, it was safe to say I think this might be my hardest challenge yet. Walking in, I thought this place didn't look so bad. They even had a chair to hold the door for new customers. Oh, how polite. Bruh. I was then seated and asked for a Coke. But they brought me a water. However, Coke is unhealthy, so they were just looking out for me. 1-star. It was now time for some food. They had pizza, sushi, roast chicken, but I decided to go with a simple meal. My utensils didn't really work, but I guess eating with my hands is more fun.
This tastes exactly like my lunch from school. Definitely a star.
And finally, I went to the bathroom and it was decorated with fine art all over the walls, which gives this place total character and charm. So, star. Time to get out of here. The best star of them all was meeting all my fans.
Chocolate seed up!
If I told you this was only gonna hurt, if I warned you that the fire's gonna burn, would you walk in? Would you let me do it first? Do it all in the name of love. Would you let me lead you even when you're blind in the darkness?
Hey, super random question for you guys. When's the last time you've been to Disneyland?
38 years ago?
Yeah. Well, I actually have 2 extra tickets with me today. Do you guys want to come with me to Disneyland?
Seriously?
Yeah, seriously.
Wow. Magnanimous of you.
Yeah, you guys want to come?
Yeah.
We'd be honored.
All right, come on, let's go.
Wow.
Go for it.
There you go.
Cheers. Woo! What'd you think of the ride?
Man, that was great. I only had to change my underwear 2 or 3 times. Oh.
Here you go.
Oh, of course.
Thank you so much, Topper, for today.
Really?
You brought back so many great
memories. A lifetime of memories in one day.
Of course, guys.
I feel 99 again.
As you guys know, I love McDonald's. But the other day, I was wondering, is it possible to just order a slice of cheese? Well, there's only one way to find out. So I tried to do it online.
Yes, American cheese, no meat, no salt, no Big Mac bun, and we should be good to go.
They just canceled my order.
Bruh.
Attempt number one failed. But then I thought of another idea, the drive-thru. I ordered a Big Mac, but asked for nothing but cheese. I think this might have worked. I opened the box and found
grilled cheese.
Bruh. I had to step this up and head inside of McDonald's. I tried the machine that was inside of the store. It took everything off the burger except for the cheese. After ordering, the workers literally called me over to make sure that they had the order right. I then got the order, opened the box, and it worked! Friend is acting suspicious. Let me explain. Every time I ask to go in his room, he says,
"No, go away."
What could he be hiding? So I offered him $10,000 to go in his room, and he said,
"Yo, what's in my room is worth way more than $10,000.
I need to figure out a way inside. And that's when I noticed he usually leaves his window open. So I flew my drone up, but he was right there and shut the blinds. I didn't know what to do, but I wasn't going to give up. So I waited for him to fall asleep and snuck in. I found my diamond play button. What was that doing in here? I also saw a red light coming from his closet. So I opened it and... Subscribe if you want to see what I found. You won't believe it. This has to be settled. Let me explain. This is my best friend Shutters, and he loves Prime. But I think Gatorade is way better.
So today, we're gonna see which one is better.
Test number one, strength.
Boom, let's go! Oh, no! Oh!
Time for test number two, taste test.
Oh, these both suck. What?
Test number three, meth.
Bruh. Like if you think Gatorade is better, and subscribe if you think Prime is better.
Today I got the best news of my life.
Free Subway for life, it'll cost you a 12 by 12 inch tattoo of a foot long thug.
So I did the obvious. I called a professional body paint artist and was given very specific instructions to pull this off. Number one, shave your chest. Number two, pay me $1,000. After both of these were complete and the sandwich was on my stomach, it was go time.
Okay, so I heard online that if you have a Subway sandwich tattoo, that you get free Subway.
One second, I have something for you. This car gives you free Subway for life.
Oh my gosh, dude, no way!
We're warming!
Here we go, Grandma. One, go.
Today I am going to send Mr. Beast the first ever Mr. Beast chocolate bar fountain. But first, I've gotta make one. So I went to the store and bought every single Mr. Beast bar I could find. I started by melting all the Beast chocolate down, and once they were all melted, it was time to pour it into the fountain.
It's working!
And now that the chocolate fountain is complete, I decided to make some treats for Mr. Beast. I made some chocolate covered strawberries, apples, more strawberries. Jimmy, I hope you enjoy these. Once they were all covered in chocolate, I had to put them in the freezer so they would all cool down. And after waiting what felt like forever, it's now time to send Mr. Beast the first ever Mr. Beast bar chocolate fountain covered fruit. I hope he appreciates this.
3, 2, 1. Okay, bro. Yo, you think you can do that blindfolded?
Easy.
Okay, ready? Here we go. Here, throw this on.
Come on. You know who I am, bro?
Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Oh my god, Ryan! Bro, that's already so impressive.
Too easy. Make it go faster.
You want it faster? All right, ready? Yeah, I'm going to hit it.
Let's go.
Oh, my God. Go. Oh, my. Bro, this is insane.
Let's go.
Oh, bro, that was a close one.
Oh, my God. Let's go.
This is the best candy, and if you disagree, you're wrong. This or that? Praying Fire Pop Rocks.
Bruh.
This or that? This. This or that? This or that?
Bruh.
This or that? Smell the rainbow.
Bruh.
This or that? Subscribe if you think this should win and like the video if you think these should win. Yellow's the best one. This or that?
This.
This or that?
This.
This or that?
This.
This or that?
Bruh.
This or that? It's so creepy! And for sure,
I bought a new pair of white shoes and decided today was the day to show them off. But then, the unimaginable happened.
My shoes, food waster.
After trying to get them professionally cleaned and using thousands of dollars worth of machinery to try and clean the shoes, yeah. I had to accept that they were goners. It was time to move forward, so I got a new pair of white shoes. This means I have to protect them at all costs. So I went to hire some backup. I had the US Marines on the case to protect my babies. But right when I thought nothing bad could happen...
Wait!
You saved my shoes.
I got you, bro.